Hello, everybody. I'm just waiting for John. I don't know where John is, but he's coming. Hello. How's it going? I don't know where it is, but I got the monsters to hunt. I don't remember what the fuck I was doing in this game. Oh, my neck hurts. I have to remember everything. Everything is going to be a mess because what's the last time I played this? I don't remember. Last time we did it. I'm trying to get all the things. Hold on, was it? I know I was working with a hammer. That's about that. But I wonder. Oh, I don't remember this village layout at all. I hope Kev will like it. Kev will like what? Hi. I practice is a real hard thing to say. It's a garb of glad tidings you put on your kohu. Oh! Oh, neat. Again. What is a garb? What does that do? Is that like an equipment thing? Well, now I have to go look. But either way, we're going to get into the online thing. Which I think was this, if I remember right. It's going to be a whole thing. Don't worry about it. I think this is the online hub. Yes. How do I invite John? Let's see. The Hub Maiden.
Welcome to the Hub.
Oh, that's where I do the actual quest. Okay. Guildstone. Sometimes when you return from a quest, Mark will hold the sale. During the sale. Oh, neat.
What?
Oh, hello. I was reading tutorials. Hi, John.
Oh.
Hi there. I was remembering where to go. There's amiibos for this game? I forgot that.
Yeah, they were. I didn't bother with them, but I know some people were buying them. I think they unlock certain outfits or something.
Oh, I thought it was going to be like I could like equip a cool monster or something.
No.
Oh.
Plus, they put out too many. They put out like 3 for Rise and then 3 more for Sunbreak, and it's just, I can't keep up with all that, so I don't.
Is there a Diablos? Because I do like Diablos.
No.
Well, damn it. Oh, that's fine. I'm in the hub. Ooh, a lottery. I don't remember if I have to invite you to get to the hub or not. Ooh, I won the lottery.
You go to the cat and you make a room.
Right. I got a bunch of barrel bombs, so that's nice. Alright, the cat. The one cat.
There's a lot of cats.
Yeah, there's a lot of cats. Okay, hold on. I'll remember. The chief? Not the chief.
The cat that's next to where the blacksmith is and across from the quest girl in the main area.
So not in the hub.
No, it's where you start the game, like outside, not in the multiplayer.
Well, why wouldn't it be in the multiplayer thing?
You would think, right? But no.
Yeah. Oh, Monster Hunter doing the thing. Okay.
Well, technically, you don't start the game in there. You start the game outside in front of the cat.
Okay, now I gotta remember where it is. Hold on, I'm gonna do it. The blacksmith is... I think I'm in the right spot. There's a cat, the fishmonger, not him. Yeah, no.
The cat standing on the box is like right in front of where the stairs are.
Okay, where the stairs are. Gotta remember that. Cat standing on the box. That guy, yeah, alright. Why wouldn't they just... whatever. I forgot. You have to turn on, like, online mode. Okay. And he gave me gifts. Alright, use this quest so you can get more likes from your first... Okay, I just want to turn it on online, sir. Okay. Play online, right? Create a lobby.
Mm-hmm.
Target, whatever. Quest type, number of players. I guess I'll leave it on 4 for now, but I'll leave a passcode because who knows if anyone wants to come in. You already know what the password's going to be, so don't you worry. Because I'm an adult. I wonder how many people make lobbies with that passcode. And they're just like, oh man, a random person came in.
Yep.
Unless I'm just a child, which is totally possible too. And then I got a garb of something goodies, and I want to know what that does.
A garb of goodies?
Yeah, I think it's in my equipment thing. I'm going to have to go look at it. I can't remember. It was like the garb of sweet something, but whatever it is, I'll figure it out. Item box. Change equipment. You know what? For the life of me, can't find it. Let's see. I don't know. Probably is something, but whatever. The hub is open, and I'm going to see if I can upgrade anything, because I don't remember what I did last. It's been a bit.
You know what's funny? I haven't played my Switch in like weeks.
That's unusual for you. Are you okay?
I know, right? No, because I was nonstop on the Switch. Because I was playing Pac-Man, and I was playing, you know, Monster Hunter, and I was playing like all this Splatoon 3 I put hundreds of hours into. And then all of a sudden, it just stopped. And now I've just been playing on the Xbox One.
It's that Scorn. Scorn got you.
Scorn and Subnautica I've been playing back-to-back. And I've just, my Switch has been collecting dust. I'm taking a pause on Splatoon. The servers are broken. I'll wait for them to fix it and I'll jump back on.
Yeah, I would think they'd fix that, you know? Hi, Chell. Yeah, I would hope they fix that soon. What was I using my hammer for? I don't remember, but I remember smashing things in the face with it. That's about it. I feel like my weapon tree is not large.
You unlock the weapon tree as you progress. You're pretty low rank right now.
Well, it's like the defender tree has like one straight line. And like everything else has like cool fun things I should do. But I guess until I find something's weakness, maybe I should just hold off on it.
You could always change up your weapons. You don't have to like dedicate to one thing. You could constantly switch back and forth.
Yeah, I should. It's like one of those things where like I want to, but I don't, but I do, but I don't, you know. Like I like dedicating down the line. I'm different, I don't know. Is my skirt pretty enough? Compare
it. Hype.
Yeah, it's fire resistance. What is one up John without a Switch? I mean, he has it. He's the other things happened.
Well, when Mario Party 1 and 2 get added, they're getting added November 2nd. I've never been into Mario Party, but I'm looking forward to playing that game maybe with other streamers.
But you didn't get the new one.
No. But what I'm saying is there's going to be part of the expansion pack, so I'll have it. But I've never bought a Mario Party, in other words.
Oh, I was going to say, because like the new one is like, it's like the greatest hit, so I'm like, oh, I don't know if I want to even like go on the NSO, because it's like, well, I can just play the greatest hits one.
Well, yeah, it's just for me, it's not like going backwards. I never went forward, so it's like...
right, okay. That was...
Yeah.
That does make more sense.
But yeah, I'll try him out.
I mean, you just got to be prepared for bullshit is the best way to play Mario Party. Like, just go in knowing that as hard as you try, the game could just decide you're not allowed to win now.
But I've seen people play, and sometimes it takes forever to even get into a mini game. You're just going around the map, and you never land on a mini game.
Every turn should be.
No, it doesn't. Like, from what I've seen, it's just kind of you have to land on the mini game square.
Oh, there's a mode for that. That could be why, but some people play that way. I like playing with every four turns. He's not going to start playing Fortnite, Chell. He will never.
You've done that. No, thank you.
I got him to try Rumbleverse, and he'll do that with me. That's about it. Let's do this. And that even is like, I'm shocked. I'll give
it all I've got. I tolerate Rumbleverse.
I mean, it's fun enough, right? It's good enough. All right. I guess I will not be upgrading my hammer for now. So there's that. What are we gonna fight? What are we gonna fight?
You pick.
That's true. I do pick. Alright, my neck hurts. Ugh. I'm going out like an adult tonight at like 9. Did I tweak my layout? I got rid of the bit counter and then I just put a little goal thing there. That's really it. Okay, guild store. That's not where I have to be. Where is the quest? I will remember. I'm gonna get it. It's the cat. It's the other cat. That's the store. Fuck. Okay, it's the lady. I lied. So we have... What's the rampage? Oh, the rampage is like the base defense thing, right?
Yeah.
We didn't like that.
I'm not finding you.
You're not?
No.
My thing's on. Hmm.
Like, I usually go, like, looking by friend, and, like, you're not popping up.
Oh, is my thing... I might be set to offline. Hold on. Oh, I forget how to do this. I am going to the Layers of Fear thing, Chell. How do I do this? Let's see. Friend list. No. Fuck, how do you set yourself to online again? User settings. Play activity settings. We're getting there. Display to friends. Okay, am I online now?
Let me check. No.
Yeah, the Legends of Fear thing. That what did I say, layers? Okay. Let me see if I can... Can I invite you? Friend list. What up, John? Playing offline. Send lobby invite. How's that?
Oh. I said, yeah, received invite from Kev. Okay, how do I open the invite?
Maybe at the cat?
Yeah, because, yeah, I've never done it this way, so let me check. Maybe the cat will...
Maybe. Yeah, we got invited out by my neighbor across the street, Chell. So.
No. We'll go. From the cat.
God, why did they make it annoying? Okay, let's see.
Yeah, how do I check my invites?
I don't know. Listen, why did they make it this way?
I don't know. I don't usually have problems. This is a Kev thing.
Lobby. Oh, it's a Kev thing. Can you type in my lobby ID? I have it on screen. Does that work?
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll try that.
Well, yeah, I didn't get the invite. So there.
What? 6D?
6D's nuts. Got him. I'm an adult.
W48D. Okay, we'll try this. Lobby not found.
How? All right, I'm gonna let's get rid of this lobby. Play online. Create a lobby. Yes. More players. Da-na-na. Maybe I'll just set. I'm gonna do a passcode just in case, because I don't know if Stitch said he might join in. 6969. Maybe now that I've made a lobby while I'm appearing online. I don't know.
Maybe.
Yeah, I don't know. I hope it works.
No, I don't see you.
What the hell?
I don't really know. We played fine online before.
Friend list. Send lobby invite. Depending on the connection.
I'm closing out my game, maybe.
Okay. Yeah. Let me see if I send it to you while you're closed out, and you can like boot the game into it. I don't know. Is that a thing?
Maybe.
Lobby settings. Quest monitor. Interconnect. Only players with specified Hunter Connect details may find it. I don't know what that means.
I'm on my friends list, and I don't see you online.
Okay, hold on. Online, how do I profile? Maybe it's here. I made myself look offline, and I don't know how to fix it on the Switch. nope, I don't want to change my name. I thought it was the play activity thing. We only want to try. Well, that's rude. Trending online play invites. I mean, I don't know if you can get it from this menu. Add friends, user settings, play activity settings. Display to all users, maybe? I don't know, whatever. Check your account, check your subscriptions. Friend settings, is this? Oh, here's the online status. It's the wrong thing. Okay.
Yay.
All right, now I bet that's it. God. All right, now we can try it.
Okay.
That was the play activity set. I thought it was the same thing. What do I know? You know?
Gamer Kev.
I am. Listen, you watch the podcast. I'm a pro gamer. You could buy a Mario Kart. Oh my God. John, do you want to buy a Mario Kart with me?
What, a real kart?
Yeah, it's for like kids, but I could probably fit.
Well, you are a kid.
Oh my God, I need this. I don't have a child to put in it, but I'll figure it out. Alright, did that work?
I'm booting up the game.
Oh right, I forgot. My starting takes a while to boot up too.
Yeah, it takes a while checking all the add-ons. So they keep adding stuff, and so it takes longer to boot up because of all the stuff they've added.
those bastards. Let's see. Not that one. Alright. We can do it. I know, I believe in this game. It'll do it one day.
Still loading.
Oh god, the Switch. Thought it was all supposed to be all the cartridges. Isn't that supposed to be fast? Where's them SSDs they talked about? The Courier Cat's cute as fuck. Chelsea has so many cats in this game, you would love it.
A lot of cats.
She's gonna be, if she wasn't married, she'd be a crazy cat lady. And I say that with love. Kinda still is, but you know, we love her for that.
Hey, I see you.
Yay! Alright, I'm gonna go in the hub. Not that hub, you perverts. Alright. Canteen. There you are.
Yay.
With your hunter rank 280? Okay, geez.
God, I'm not trying to flex.
It's a big flex. I said it with love. Order the usual. What was my usual? Sure. Sounds great. There's so many cats. Why? I wonder why they went with cats. I mean, I know Japan loves them.
Cats are a thing.
I'm not against them. I do love me a good kitty. Oh, there you are. Hello. Wow, you look... That's a lot of blue. Look at you. With a mushroom on the head. Of course. Alright, let's do... Oh, no. We have level ones to finish. We can kill a... Oh, that's the lame ones. That's why we didn't do that. Now I remember. Hunt a Volvidin. What kind of monster is that? It looks like a giant ball. Alright. I believe in us. Protect you. I did eat. Oh, look at you. Oh, Amaterasu. I forgot you had that.
Yep.
Oh, I want that.
You can do it, but I don't know if you can do it at your level, but you have the quest for it.
Oh, okay. So we'll do that eventually then. Hub quest gate to pay. No, I'll wait for the person to be ready. The person. I kind of look like if Shredder learned what gold was.
Yes.
With Killzone eyes, actually. I am intimidating. Jeez, look at me. We are good. I appreciate everyone listening to the podcast this morning. Please download it. We need downloads. Thanks.
I'm ready.
All right. Adventure! Hell yeah. And these electric cars are getting cheaper. I do want an electric car, eventually. Maybe I can get an electric truck, that's what I want. One day. And I'll drive in New York, where there's all those charging stations. Mm-hmm. Actually, do they have those in New York? I feel like that's what they would really have.
We don't have gas stations, why would we have charging stations?
I don't know, I figured maybe they were like, ah, if we don't have gas stations, we'll do this.
I haven't seen them.
Oh, well, never mind then. Okay, I'm trying to get reacclimated with my menu thing.
Yeah, did you know electric cars are worse for the environment?
Yes and no. They kind of are, they kind of aren't.
A lot of mining has to be done to get the things to make the batteries. And yeah. The mining is worse for the environment than drilling for oil.
That is true. But I just don't want to pay for gas.
Yeah. But either one is bad. I don't like how they're like, this is better. It's like, no, not really.
Yeah, it's definitely not great, but I just don't want to pay for gas. Was there a sprint button? I don't remember.
Yes.
What was
hold
that?
Down R.
R. Oh, it's also my dog, too. Which was, yay. Carl!
Hello.
How you doing, Carl? All right, I'm running with the dog. I'm coming. Where is this stupid thing? Did you find it already? Or are you just fighting little things?
I'm fighting a cat.
How dare the cats? Whoop. How do I jump off my dog? UFC 280. Oh, 280. I forgot that's on right now, too. Stream's good. We just started, but stream's good. We finally figured out how to play online.
Kev is butching. Carl's butching.
He's butching. Is he butchering?
I don't know.
That's bad. Is that bad for the environment too? Where is this big enemy thing?
And while you're around, try to pick up those birds.
The birds. Oh, yeah.
Spirit birds.
Okay. So I'm trying not to, like, immediately run to the monster, but it's already in the top right if I see. Why is it already out there for me? That's weird. Eh. I just want to carve all the little animals I see, because I'm an environmentalist. I love Monster Hunter. It's just, I was waiting on a friend to give it back, and then, you know, it didn't. So I finally got, I just said fuck it and bought it. So now me and John can play. And then eventually I'll do the single player stuff. But there's too many games right now. I gotta beat Bloodstained. The final boss fight's really, really kicking my ass. And I really hate that the advice somebody found for me, actually Jeff, was like, just get good! I was like, okay, cool, thanks. Like, pretty much...
This fight looks confusing.
It kind of is. Like, I had the timing down. I can get through the first stage, no problem. It's just the second stage. I'll like, mistime one thing, and then it's just like, what if you died right now? So, I'm gonna get there. I want to beat the game, and it's recommended 5 to 15 hours.
Is there a pattern with that boss fight?
Kind of. The hitbox on the enemy, like the big heads, is kind of weird. So, like, if you land on them, then the enemy is just, like, damages you. So I just have to, like, learn the hitbox of the giant heads. And they're all different, because one has, like, extra spikes on them. So.
Remember how, like, impossible the Metroid Dread final boss looked? But then once you get the pattern, it's like, yeah. I got it.
Well, so the pattern on this one, like, I have to get into a flow. Once I'm in a flow of the game, I'm like, okay, I can do this. And I get closer and closer, but then, like, oh, I have to go to practice. Or, The Bachelor in Paradise was on last night, so I had to watch that with Tina. Listen, it's a great show. It's so dumb and stupid. Like, these people are acting like they're in fully committed relationships with people they've known for, like, a week. Like, I can't believe you're cheating on me with this other girl. It's like, dude, you've known each other for a week. You need to...
They become very emotionally invested, considering they're all strangers.
Yeah, and you know what? They're all beautiful people. Like, I'm sure you're going to find somebody real fast, even on a superficial level.
Yeah, they get, like, suicidal if they don't get chosen. It's like, oh, you're going to be okay. You're going to find somebody. Like,
and not... Yeah, and then, like, even if they don't win, one person's picked for the next season, and everyone else comes back for, like, this paradise thing where they're just, like, on a desert island with the other people that were on the show once. Mm. And then it's just, like, it's just a bunch of people circle jerk, like... Beautiful people out here being pretty, and then they go, I can't believe nobody likes me, as they're making millions off, like, sponsorships and, like, stuff from being on The Bachelor. I'm like, I think your life is gonna be all right. Oh my god, don't hurt me. And it's really easy to be in a loving relationship when you're on a beach vacation and you don't have to talk about anything real in life.
You should do the show, and then, like, the reveal, he's married!
He's already married, and then his wife is here to beat his ass, like...
Yeah, that would be really funny.
Tina, I'm just going on a vacation for a week, it's no big deal, bro. As Woody Allen once said, too invested, too aggressive, let me take a step backward. Yes! Yeah, and exactly, we don't have to talk about taxes or, like, what you do for work or, like, anything else. Yeah, it's easy to fall in love with somebody when you go, whoa, titties. Or, like, whoa, look at them short shorts. That guy looks great in those.
And don't they have, like, endless booze?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. They got to fuel with alcohol. Otherwise, like, what are you doing? One dude was there, and his whole personality was, I own pizza stores. And, like...
That's pretty cool.
Well, it was cool, but, like... Wait, first of all, they were... No, it was in Florida, so who knows how good they were.
Okay.
And then number two... How do I get this poop off here? I need to get this poop off. But, like, he wouldn't ask the girl he was on a date with, like, any questions about herself. He was just like, yeah, so I opened this pizza store, and we're franchising out. I'm thinking about moving to New York. And she was like, cool. So me, he's like, yeah, so I'm just thinking, like, if we franchise, okay, dude. Like, that was his whole personality. So get this. I did some Goth Nights off stream, do a kind of find the story, the game's fine without better capture software. Carl, that goes into what we were saying today. I bet your PC is just having trouble running the game and streaming. That could be it.
Wait, you were playing the PC version, right? Yeah, see, that's the problem. Streaming and playing on the same PC, that's going to have issues.
Console Master Race. Mm-hmm. I don't watch these shows, but I do remember the show Married at First Sight. Love that show. But the guys had telling him he was leaving. They took every single thing apart. They were sure. Yo, all these trash shows. Love it. I got to watch Too Hot to Handle, too. That sounds like another great show I got to watch. That show, I don't even know. Have you even heard the concept of that show before, John?
No.
So essentially, you put a bunch of hot people on an island. There's a pattern here. And if they touch each other in any kind of, like, ooh-woo way, money gets taken out of, like, a giant pool that they're all trying to compete for.
Oh.
So, like, yeah, I gotta watch. I love trash TV. The OBS for sure is that. Yeah, it's just too many resources. This is why consoles are great. I gotta get this poop off me. I can't use my potions. What is the correlation between smelling bad and using potions? It doesn't make sense.
Item, I think it's deodorant or cleanser, one of those.
Yeah, I think it's cleanser. Yeah. Or deodorant. Just put some deodorant on.
Throw this in a gamer.
I was gonna say, this is a Smash Brothers tournament. Mm. You're allowed to wear it. Or a multiverses tournament. Who do you think smells worse, Smash Brothers or Multiverses people?
I saw one that there was a guy who dubbed himself the deodorant guy, and he was just walking around, like, deodorizing the gamers. And I'm like,
that
he's doing God's
great.
Work.
Did you see the guy at Magic the Gathering tournaments who would go around and take pictures with people's ass crack showing in chairs?
Yeah.
I love that guy.
So that's a thing with Magic the Gathering players?
It's just anywhere. He just decided every time somebody had a plumber's crack, he would go down and, like, thug pose by it.
But isn't that, like, sexual harassment?
He didn't touch him. And then you're putting your butt out there in public. I don't know.
That's true. It's not like putting a cam under a girl's skirt. I mean,
that's weird.
These guys are exposing their crack for the world.
Listen, a nice little electrician's crack, maybe? So, Captain, watch Temptation Island because my childhood crush from cute. Who is your childhood crush, Ziggy? I need to know. And Carl, yes, switch to the Xbox version. Play on console, you'll have a great time, promise. It's capped at 30. I don't know if you've heard. And also cost $10 more for reasons.
Yeah, I don't like this new trend that's been happening now.
I mean, as much as I like Call of Duty, I ain't buying it for $70.
Because the $70 price tag was just for PS5, but now Xbox is doing it.
Yeah, at least it's not like their first party stuff. Because their first party stuff's going to be on Game Pass. Hey, yo. Unless you're Call of Duty, because PlayStation's crying. Who's your childhood crush? Mine's Victoria Justice. Or Jamie Lynn Spears.
God, you're young.
I know.
92.
Listen,
you Rosalina. Disney Channel and shit.
Sometimes I did. It wasn't my go-to channel. I was a Nickelodeon guy, really. Oh, yeah. I didn't watch that show, but I know who you're talking about, Zig. Who's your childhood crush, John?
I don't know.
Too far back to remember the 1300s?
You know, 200-300 years ago.
So. Your favorite stage play person?
Yes. Yes.
What was the entertainment back then? Oh, this thing's tired. We almost got it. We're good. You got it by the balls, if it's got balls. Share birthday that. Well, there you go. That's your opening line. That bomb hurt
What's
me.
Up?
That Excellent. Bomb hurt me. Stitch is on.
Yay!
Wonderful, join us. Come on, Houndoom. We ride. I really want a puppy, and I would name it Houndoom. Oh, God! I love Monster Hunter Ziggy. Oh, it's a big... Oh, excuse me, iguana. I love it. It's good. I'm happy I definitely got my copy back from a friend. An acquaintance.
Sure you did.
Yeah, no, this is my real physical cartridge. What are you talking about? That I got from Chase in a trade. What did I send him for that? Oh, Ultimate Muscle. I remember that. I forget how you get on monsters' backs like that, too.
Oh, when they're dizzy, you just press A near them. That's it.
Oh, that's it. Eh. Woo. But I'm having fun. John's kind of... I feel like I'm still kind of challenged by the monsters. It must scale pretty well.
I'm nerfing myself for you.
How are you nerfing it?
Well, I'm just using the bow. Like, the bow does, like, chip damage, mostly. So
oh.
I'm just kind of letting Kev get the kill, in other words.
I thought it was scaling well. You're just giving me sympathy.
Yeah.
Hey. Thank you for the sympathy. Mm-hmm. Oh, God. Time to die! Oh, God. I feel like I don't do any damage on the back. If we were a monster, which one would... I would be a Diablos. I think that thing looks the coolest as hell. What monster would you be, John?
Well, I kind of like the Pookie Pookie.
That thing's cute, too.
I like that chicken dinosaur that holds the rock.
A Yoshi.
Yes, that one.
He's kind of a Yoshi. There's the, what's the big old bear-looking one? Or it kind of looks like a sloth. I can't remember what its name is.
Oh, I would be maybe the bunny. That big, scary
Oh, the bunny's bunny. Cute.
He's like a were-bunny.
Horrifying. Hi, Stitch. We just saw you online.
Hey. Yeah, see, Stitch made an emote of it. The chicken holding the egg.
That's what it is.
Or it's a heart. It's a heart-shaped rock.
That's kind of adorable, though.
Yeah, my TV is a monster that uses a weapon against you, which is pretty cool.
He's advanced. I gotta sharpen my hammer, which is still hilarious to me every time I have to do this. Horrible, but all it. Come on, you can't be horrible. There's good vibes only. It's a law. It is 6969 Stitch, because I'm a child. And if you want to get on voice, let us know. I'll get you in there. Oh, I need stamina too. Shit. I forgot I need stamina. Bum, bum, bum.
Yay.
I hear him. After this hunt, Stitch, I'll send you the Discord-y thingy if you want it. Eh. No. Oh god, get the fuck out of here. He's tired. Do we have... Yeah, we don't need it. Never mind. I'm not against it, it's fine. I still get stuff, I can carve him now.
There you go.
Carve. No part of the body goes un... what's the thing called? Wasted, there we are. Words are hard today. Let's see. Where's my voice thing? Free invite. Da-da-da. I don't have Stitch on Discord. Oh well. Stitch, it'll be in your Twitter DMs. There we are. Did I carve him enough? I did.
Carving hype.
I gotta carve a pumpkin too, speaking of which.
People carve very creative things into pumpkins.
I try to do, like, you know, like, it's like you don't make a hole in the pumpkin, but you shave it away so, like, light still comes through. I don't know how to do that. That's the real wizard stuff.
It'd be cool to do like a monster hunter, like dragon looking thing.
Oh, I'm not that talented. I did Tomb Link one year and I was pretty proud of that. Oh, no problem, Stitch. You don't have to be on voice. You just have to hear our voices.
Stitch is shy.
Oh, we love you, Stitch. I will take all. Why would I not want all the rewards? Better question. Bum, bum, bum. I wonder if Discord will end up on Switch. They did it on Xbox.
I haven't tried that, have you?
I haven't? He's in the Discord. Wait, will he hear him? Did he lie to me? I have not tried it though, but like my PC's right here, so like why am I really gonna make a stress about it, you know?
I feel like that would have been a bigger deal a while ago. It's just like, I think people are just accustomed to just using Discord on the app or in a browser or whatever.
Yeah.
You know, I don't feel like they really need it on the Xbox.
No. I feel silly that time I made fun of Nintendo and their setup, but like, now I use my PC for voicing and I'm like, oh. Okay, I guess they were onto something. The setup was weird, but they were onto something. 150. Oh, jeez. I don't have like any element on my hammer. That's the problem. I just don't really need it. Iron hammer. What am I using here? Defender hammer. Yeah, it's fine. I like the way you think. Rampage skills. Don't care about that. So what can I help you with? I just want to get the best armor I can, man. We need to kill more Wraithians. And these greaves. Well, I don't need those either. Something new or an upgrade? Rick, god damn it. I gotta turn that shout off thing. You give Rick an inch and he takes a mile.
Mm-hmm.
Leave it to me. Hello, Rick. How are you? Podcast host Rick.
Yep.
All right, purchase can say. I am pretty good, I think. I am that one. All right, I'm ready to fight the next thing.
Well, you have to pick the next thing.
Oh, right. I keep forgetting that. I feel like I always think it's going to be a, like, we can all do it thing. All right, let's see what we can fight. Look, a 615. Okay, Stitched. God. I'm just a baby.
Stitch is OP.
I know. All right, we got to kill Blasted Becerios. We're going to defend everyone so they have a place to rise. Oh, shit. Then I'm going to change that. Fuck that. That's why it makes sense. Thank you, Stitch.
No, Stitch, you might be OP with that hammer. You're going to end up killing it before Kev even touches the monster, so.
Well, he was saying how the Defender Hammer is kind of like a baby hammer.
All right, baby hammer hype.
All right, I'm going to make a new hammer real quick. Sorry, guys. This one. What we got here? We're going to make a good hammer. All right, I'm down a new tree. I'm going down the bone tree. Screw it. Don't hold back. Listen, we got monsters to kill. I'm ready to boost through the multiplayer. So when I go in the single player, I could be a wizard. And I gotta eat. Oops.
Stitch is not holding back.
Listen, kill him. Kill him in the face. Pay with points, order the usual. Great. Don't watch the cats dance. This arrives at Sunbreak. Okay. Let's hit it. Rip, the monsters will die. Hello, Chaz. We kill them monsters around here. They did nothing to us, but we will ruin their days. Again, we're kind of the villains in this game.
Yes. PETA would not approve.
I wonder if they've made us think about Monster Hunter before.
They made us think about Pokemon.
Yeah, they made us think about Mario, so why not?
Well, yeah, he does, like, stomp and kill turtles.
No, I think it was the Tanuki skin. They were all offended by.
Well, Mario did skin a Tanuki to put on its skin, so.
I played this for the first butt time in months just yesterday, buddy.
But
nice.
But.
It's all good, Chaz. All right, let's go fight everybody. Where's my dog?
Yeah. I took a big break. Like, I haven't been playing the recent updates, so I'm out of the loop when it comes to what they're doing in Sunbreak right now.
What's this monster?
Doesn't even have Sunbreak.
I just got this game back. So. I'm going to kill this little thing first. I'm going to try to get all the material I can, because now I need a new hammer to build. Because I was too busy using the baby hammer. Just the baby. Alright, there we are. Renopolis, I'm sorry I hurt you. Watch, I'm gonna, like, get to the monster. Stitch is already like, I killed three of them. Mm-hmm. Alright. Riding on cars. What area is it in?
Eight.
Okay. Oh, it's that one. Okay. Taking the long trail, apparently.
Me too.
Where's the... Ooh, herbs. Give me them. I do like the auto-mixing. That's, like, such a big, like, help in this game.
Yep.
Last time I touched my Switch. Yeah, I guess everyone's just dumping their Switches. Just
yeah,
kidding.
Yeah, Chaz, I was talking about, I haven't played my Switch in, like, weeks. I just kind of, like, after I got burned out on Splatoon 2, I was like, I'm gonna just play my Xbox.
I need a Steam Deck, that's why. It's like a Switch, but not. I mean, I'm probably going to use it to only play, like, I'm going to treat the Steam Deck like a console. That's the thing. I'm not going to be upgrading its parts. What do you think I am?
How do I well, get at least you it? Don't have to run PC games on the same PC you're streaming from now.
I would never.
Steam Deck, so.
That just sounds like disappointment. How do I get to Area 8?
Okay, yeah, I'm confused, too. I think it's above, because I'm below. Oh. So,
okay.
Yeah.
I'm gonna climb every wall I can. There was that's the grappling hook button. Alright. Whoop. God damn it. And I jumped off the yeah, how do I climb again?
R.
Yeah, but I keep like kick flipping off the wall.
I don't know why. Just go up to the wall and hold down R.
Kickflip. Parkour.
If it's a wall you can't climb, that's cool. Yeah.
I see. Oh, gee. Okay. I can only climb certain... Fuck, how do I get up there? Stitch, don't kill everything. I mean, or do. It's fine. I'll take the credit. There's a Retroid Pocket 3. Oh, there's a Retroid Pocket 3? Well, that'd be cool, actually. I did like my Retroid Pocket when I had it.
It's funny that people bought that Logitech thing just to like do a review saying how crappy it is.
Yeah, I don't know. It's worthless if I leave the house. I don't know. Like, remote play kind of works on anything, so like I don't really get the point of that.
It's basically like if you liked the Wii U gamepad, then maybe you would like that Logitech thing.
Yeah, I really like not being able to leave my house to use this portable thing.
Yeah.
That's weird. I don't know. Apparently it can run emulators pretty well, though, so... Oh, I guess if you like that, sure.
There's just a lot of different options, so I don't really see why you have to get that, and it's completely overpriced.
Yeah, 300 is a little...
You could buy a much cheaper device that does the same thing and more, so...
If it was 100, I would strongly consider it. Just to like
Emberneck was $100 and it could run like any emulator pretty much. So
I just want to emulate Dreamcast without issue. That's really what I want to do.
Dreamcast run some games run better than others, but it does play Dreamcast.
That could actually be useful. I finally made it here. And now he's leaving. God dang it.
Oh.
Oh. Because I want to play Crazy Taxi 2.
Crazy Taxi 2 is interesting.
I mean, is 3 any good? I've never played 3 either.
Yeah, 3 is like a best of, because you have Crazy Taxi 1, 2, and 3 in there.
That's really cool.
It's good.
Logic so long before they lose money and parts are so cheap. Well, it's kind of a dumb product in the first place.
Yeah, I feel like if that device came out a few years ago, it would have been more of a big deal.
It's just, like, what's the point of...
5 years ago.
It's like, what's the point of a cloud gaming device that you always need Wi-Fi? O'Malley and Yannis. Don't spoil it, Carl. I gotta watch it tomorrow. Peace and love. I gotta watch the fights tomorrow. I forgot it was on at 2:00 today, but I can handle that tomorrow. All I want to know is if Hospula gets in the Octagon. Oh my god, I forget how you lock up. Love you, Carl. Thank you. I hope I don't sound rude. But I got money on O'Malley. And by money, I mean nothing at all, because I don't bet. Everyone in my job site like bets on football games. I can only imagine how much money they've lost. I get anxiety if I go to the blackjack table and lose like $10. Send me to the arcade at the casino. That's where I want to go.
Apparently, they're going to open up a casino in Times Square.
Oh, that's actually not the worst idea. I feel like that'd be a good spot for one. Get some more traffic up in there, you know?
Yeah, because we need more traffic in Times Square.
Well, they're all waiting for gas, and you know?
It's just a bunch of cars circling around. Where's the gas station?
Oh, guys, we didn't plan this at all. Yeah, there's like $5 tables at a casino near me, Chaz, and honestly, that's all I'm willing to spend on gambling.
Slots.
Listen, I won a penny slot jackpot once, and then an old lady hit on me in front of Tina. Got him. Nice. I won like a $30 half penny jackpot, and some 6-year-old comes up to me and think, wow, look at you. And I'm like, this takes no skill. As like, just completely like ignoring the fact that Tina's right there. She's bold and drunk. 30 and black. Listen, $30 a hand. You know what I can do with $30? How many games of Tekken I can play in the arcade? I don't need that. I did it. I'm gonna give Stitch a thumbs up and John a thumbs up.
Yay.
I don't know what that does, but I gave it there.
It says Kev liked you.
I do like you guys. Ooh woo.
Yeah, this monster's tough because your weapon can bounce off of it. It has very tough skin. It's all rocks.
That's why I figured the hammer. Like that what is it, the Barith? Is the one with the big flat head. Like I feel like I always need I always need a hammer for that thing. It takes forever otherwise. I could be wrong.
This is a rock dragon type Pokemon.
I am excited. I hope that thing I saw about the performance issues on Pokemon isn't real. I'm waiting to see if it actually, like, when it actually comes out.
I didn't hear about that. What's that?
There was some preview build. People were like, oh, the frame rate's kind of meh, but, like, it's such a good game. And I was like, well, wait till it's actually out then.
That sounds like every Pokemon game.
Oh, my God.
Well, but it's fun.
John, I tagged you in something on this water because I think you need this controller.
Oh, no.
Yes, you do. It's Isabel.
An Isabel controller?
Power A.
You know, Isabel's like super duper popular in Japan.
I believe that. I need more Power A controllers. I want the Spectrum one for my Switch. I like the pretty lights. All right. Do I have enough to upgrade my hammer? I would like to.
Yeah, it's just weird that they would come out with that controller now. Looking for
something new? Yeah, I don't know why they waited so long. Hmm. There's reasons, I guess. I don't even know what that hammer. Ooh, what's that? Aerial shell. What? Why does the sharpness have like two levels of green? It's like a step down green. That's weird.
There's different levels of sharpness.
Well, it's like you know how it goes red, orange, yellow, and then there's like a half a bar of green, and then below it another bar of green. Powerful equipment
is important. Yeah, but that one's better than if it was just yellow.
I'll take it. Mm-hmm. Can I get new armor? Just tell me what you need. I don't know. So what can I help you with? Barrios armor, but I don't need none of that yet. I have to kill like 40 of them. Alright, more murder. How long did it take you guys to get like crazy hunter rank like that?
I think I have like 200 hours. So.
Oh, Jesus Christ, okay.
Yeah.
Got other games to play, guys.
Stitch probably has like 1,000 hours.
Got it. I hate these ones that's like slay 20 whatevers. Those are lame. Alright, let's do some bouncing brawlers. Hunt a Lagombi and a Tetradon. Can't eat. Why can't I eat? Oh, because you're sitting there. Eat a meal. Pay the points. What does this do? Short period of time eating. Let's see. I don't use kunai. Can I please show off just for text?
I played 274 hours.
Jesus.
So yeah, Stitch, if you go to your guild card, go to the third page and it'll say how your play time. And then we're all gonna be surprised.
This helps everyone because Stitch is a god. Sure, I'll order this. Forget it, I have to skip that. Alright. Let's kill these two monsters, as I definitely don't get carried and I totally pull my weight. Depart. I don't know if a million, I don't even know if anyone's been, you even been alive for a million hours? I guess I could look up, I bet you I can Google how many hours since I was born.
People have posted like screenshots of like on their Switch, like 1,000 hours for this or that. Like Animal Crossing, some people have put 1,000 hours in.
How many hours has it been since July 7, 1992? 265,000 hours. Mm. I don't know why I had to know that right now, but I did. Mm. Where's the box? There it is.
Which one are we fighting first? The bunny or the Psyduck?
Those were both descriptive. Is the bunny the 1x9?
Yes.
Let's do the bunny. Psyduck can wait. I know you want to murder Psyduck.
He does look like a really cool like evolution of Psyduck. Like his final evolution, he just turns into this big giant platypus looking King K. Rool thing.
Better than Golduck.
Yeah, I don't like Golduck. It just doesn't look like an evolution that Psyduck would have. You know what I mean? Nah. It looks nothing like Psyduck.
It's weird that, like, Psyduck should really be called Golduck. Because he's, you know, gold. And then when Psyduck evolves into Golduck, then he really gets psychic power. So I feel like that's when it should, like, change.
I also don't get the name Golduck. Yeah, I don't know why it's named that.
They got Golbat. Maybe it's a Japanese thing.
Maybe.
It's like they call it the new 3DS. Like, apparently it sounds different in Japan. Like, it makes more sense.
I didn't think about that. But yeah, maybe it does sound different. But yeah, new 3DS sounds terrible. They should have just maybe called it something different here. But again, Nintendo's very Japanese-centric. They don't really think about how things are translated in America, even though we're a huge gaming market. So I'm just very confused. I don't know why.
I would have taken Super 3DS.
Yes, that would have been cool. They don't use Super anymore. Like, literally since the Super Nintendo, they never use Super. And I'm like, why? Why Super Game Boy? That was great.
The new Super 3DS U and Knuckles. Featuring Dante from the Devil May Cry series. Mm. Ooh, stupid rabbit. Tricks are for kids.
Yeah, this is the Tricks Bunny. He evolved and he's angry.
He's mad that they took the shapes away.
Yeah, when a kid says silly rabbit, tricks are for kids, he turns into this.
Just goes on a rampage. He's like, I'm tired of you kids. I know what I saw. God dang it.
Get out the way.
I thought it was because he was attacking. I was like, I'm safe. He was not safe. I have Trank Bombs, but I don't have any traps. Which is unfortunate. Eh. Oh, God. Fuck. Oh, he's dead. Alrighty.
I think Stitch put him to sleep. Or really dead.
Oh, I can carve him, so yeah.
Oh, he's dead. Wow. That was quick.
Thanks for the support.
Nice.
Oh, jeez, I can carve a bunch of them. All right.
We can make time. Bunny burgers.
Where's the side? Oh, don't want a bunny burger. That's so sad. Welcome to hell, Jesus Christ, Stitch.
That looks like a dragon with a vagina head. What was going on there?
I don't know. It's the opposite of H.R. Giger. Bunch of dick aliens everywhere. I think that's another way I can't play Scorn. Just like too many vainy dicks everywhere, man.
Yeah. Toward the end, you actually see your character's penis. I'm not joking.
Oh, wow. Cool. I'm good.
Yeah. It's, yeah.
Is it girthy?
It's not girthy, but it's long.
Good for him.
Yeah.
I guess if you're gonna throw it in a game. What the? Why?
Yeah.
I don't need to see video game character, like, parts ever. Even, like, when there's, like, boobs in games, I'm like, why? Who's the weirdo that sat at the computer modeling this? I was like, yeah, I gotta.
There's an audience for it. Look at the weebs.
You're not wrong. Did someone say penis? Oh, yeah. Oh, Carl, did we say penis?
That woke Carl up.
Carl, did you? Oh, I tried your shoulder lock today, Carl, and I almost hurt somebody because they refused to tap, and that's their fault. But I can't help it. Get the. This is not a side. Oh, I guess it kind of looks like a side duck. He's like a ghillie suit side duck. Carl, did you play Scorn? Yeah, it really would ziggy. I mean, I got heel hooked today. I was like, listen, this ain't worth tearing my ACL. It's okay.
See, I'm toward the end of Scorn, but I'm just completely lost. Like, I saw Static get through it, but I'm confused on where I'm supposed to go. That there's like three layers, and there's like a maze, and there's no map, and I'm like, what? Yeah. So I'm confused.
I don't know. I heard it was less Doom and more Mist. So yes.
It's very Mist. So
yeah, I was like, I don't really need that in my life.
It's just a lot of cryptic, like, what the hell do I do? And yeah.
Oh, my favorite. Can you imagine me playing that?
But it's a very creative game. I'm curious to see what else they would do.
I don't know. Just maybe less dick puzzles. Are there any puzzles involving the dick? Somebody wants to buy my GameCube stuff. Ooh.
Nice.
Not all of it, but...
What GameCube stuff are you selling?
I don't know. I mean... I don't know. If I can't get on something else... I mean, all my stuff's pretty much, like, open. And I'll, like, if somebody wants something, I'll just have to look at it, like, piece by piece. But, like, yeah, I can get rid of that, you know? Like, Melee, I don't care. I'm not going to play Melee anytime soon. I want to get it still. Gold Duck is Gold Duck because in the Japanese version of Gen 1 and 2, gold is used as a symbol to represent psychic-type Pokemon. The Marsh Badge, for example, is known as the Gold Badge in Japan. Oh, okay.
I didn't know that. Okay, thanks for the info.
Now I know. Who gave Alakazam the extra spoon? That's what I want to know. Where did he get that? Where did he steal it from?
Do you think Nintendo would allow something like Scorn on the Switch?
No. No. Well, they do allow hentai weeb boob games on the eShop now, so who knows? Maybe they do, maybe they don't. Oh, Nintendo's got a weird subjective, like, we'll allow this hentai game, but not that one. We don't want Devil's Third on the Wii U, but we'll publish it. They're very strange sometimes. It's a very weird company.
Well, the problem with Nintendo is they're not consistent. Like, they'll do something for one game or in one circumstance, but not the other. And it just doesn't really make sense.
Nope. I don't know. Somebody take Miyamoto's phone. Excellent. Let's see. I got pretty nails now.
Looking for something new or an upgrade?
Looking for something new and an upgrade, sir. Okay. Did it.
Thanks.
I keep forgetting Carl's on Hawaii time, so whenever he says he's like waking up, I'm like, what are you doing? Trade materials for scraps. Why would I do that? I can have a little poison stick? Oh my god, my Palico.
Poison stick hype. Yeah, your dog and your cat have the same default outfits, don't they?
I think so. You can give him a requires forging material, yes. He's adorable. I'm trying to think learn how I do stuff for scrap. Scraps obtained, yes, okay. Oh, he's adorable now. I forget that I don't bring him into battle right now, but you know, he's a cutie pie. I don't know, where do you upgrade the dog at? Same cat?
Right next to the blacksmith, there's a cat, and that's how you upgrade.
Oh, okay, so it's the same guy. Alright. Do that. Great white clouds, puffy and light. Okay, well, we fight. What's next on the thing? I'm just running through this. Hello. Well, probably because you guys are helping, but still. I'm going to pretend I get a thing. I'll hunt all target monsters. Is that a Rathalos? I'm in.
Nice.
Don't know what's going to happen. I think I'm ready to fight everything.
Oh, it's just using the bagpipes.
Oh, good. The most non-annoying weapon ever.
I tried using that, and I just couldn't. But it's basically a hammer, but you could, like, you know, play stuff and give people stat boosts.
Yeah. I don't like really doing the support stuff in this. Last time I played a support character was Overwatch. What are these? Cure for poison?
I think it's really fucked up for people who have put like hundreds and thousands of hours into Overwatch and like they're like, fuck you.
Yeah. I don't know. That whole game seems cursed.
It's like you can no longer play the first game and then we have all these requirements for you to play the second one. and you can't even use your original stuff for
characters.
And it's just it's a big fuck you to
people. So I have the first disc for PS4. I don't know why I got it on a disc. And apparently if you pop that disc in now, it'll just say, like, it'll just download Overwatch 2. And, like, Overwatch 1 is gone. Like the icon on the PS4 changes and everything.
I don't like that.
Found the sponge lion. I always forget this thing's name.
Sponge lion.
That's what he looks like.
He is a sponge lion.
He's very absorbent and porous. He's like SpongeBob.
This is what SpongeBob turns into when he's angry.
Does SpongeBob get angry? Yeah, Gary the snail.
Well, when Patrick and him were raising that clam, he got angry. Like, oh, this poop!
The story mode for Overwatch 2 is still in development. Then don't release the game! What's the point?
Modern gaming.
Like, I will not spend real money on multiplayer games anymore. To buy them. I'll still buy some Fortnite skins. But, like, it's just like, I don't know. Wait till your game's finished now. I've just learned my lesson.
Yeah, you can't buy games at launch anymore, and it's sad because you want to buy it at launch. You're hyped up to play this game, but you can't because it's broken, it's not done, it's whatever. It sucks.
Yeah. I don't know why, man. I just wait for games to go on sale. We'll get patched by then, and they're cheaper.
It's sad because the hardcore fans are the ones that buy it day one, and they're the ones that get screwed over.
Thanks for beta testing for me. I don't know.
Yeah.
Battleborn was a better game. Actual story, controller design more creative. Just Kahiki's Gearbox is a long company. I think Battleborn had more issues than that, but
that didn't last long.
Yeah, they came out being like, we're good, the Overwatch killer, but we're a different game. We promise. And also, EA was not in the best standing at the time. It's kind of the same reason Anthem just died. Like, people were not very happy with EA, and nor did they trust him. But, yeah, my buddy tried to get us to play Battleborn, and we were all like, nope, that's okay. But it's like $5 for, like, there's probably a reason. It's like, do you remember Brink?
Yeah.
That Bethesda shooter that, like, there? It was announced first, but what came out first, Chaz?
So many, and it's hard to keep track. That's the thing, is that the market's oversaturated with many games that are like that. So you have to really bring something different, and they're not.
Yeah. I mean, even if it came out first, PUBG was out before Fortnite. Look what stayed around more.
Well, I remember when PUBG came out, it was super glitchy, like just broken.
On consoles it was.
Yes. So everyone just kind of migrated to Fortnite.
Yeah. I mean, you know, sometimes it's not about who did it first, it's about who does it best. Mm. Which is subjective, but, you know, player numbers are a stat. I don't have any great wire bugs. Well, I have some okay wire bugs, Rude. Mm. They may not be great, but they're trying their best.
Mm.
I'm here. Oh, fuck, the thing's loud. Thanks for playing music while we're fighting, Stitched. Needed a sick beat. I always wondered that.
It's like the violinists that were playing while the Titanic was sinking.
Yeah, they're like, oh, might as well have fun.
Mm.
Or like, whenever like I think about like in history class, the Revolutionary War, like that one drummer kid was like, yo, I got a sick beat for these British. Going down. Attack and ride Wyvern? I'd love to. You won't let me. Oh, I kind of wanted to try Brink, but then I heard the story mode was like a tutorial. That was about it. Oh, I'm poisoned. Shit. I picked up those things. Where are they? There they are. Use the thing.
Use the thing.
I couldn't unpoison myself. I was scared. All right. Murder this dude. Actually, you know what was a weird game? Remember Anthem? Did you ever hear how the name of the game was decided on the day of E3?
Really?
Yeah, they kept shooting names and they didn't even have a name ready. Somebody just said Anthem. They're like, great, put it in the presentation.
That's stupid.
Yeah, that shows great planning on that end. Kill the Wraithian! Yay! Send. Where am I? I hate that when it changes the camera angle because they can't see where I am. I want to pick stuff up. Give me your body. Stormo being suspended sounds like Halo Infinite. Listen, the Halo campaign was okay. It was just... It was the most unnecessary open world I've ever seen in my life.
Hmm.
But it was... What's this?
I don't know.
What is this, Stitch? What's this apple here? It looks like it's from Earthbound.
Yeah, it looks like an apple flying saucer.
Earthbound. Got it. I need to play Mother 3, too. Oh, it's a mine. Oh. It's a mine, Mario.
The whole community kind of, like, turned me off to playing Mother 3.
Why? Is it bad?
No, I mean, just, I don't know. Just people, like, port begging and... I don't know. It just, all of it kind of turned me off.
I mean, I don't see why... It's done. It's out there. It's just, why wouldn't they?
You know? That's why I don't understand all the port begging. It's like, you could just play... You know, you have ways of playing it, so just play that. Like, I don't understand the port.
I mean, I want to support the official release if there is one, and, like, be nice, but they just don't want it to happen.
Mm.
Why does Nintendo hate us?
Well, there's questionable things that would not translate well in English.
Listen, we're adults, Nintendo. I hate to tell you this, but we can handle it. You guys can't handle this game, but go play Hentai eShop game 46. It's different.
Well, technically, Nintendo's not the one making these Hentai games.
They sure aren't stopping it either.
No. Well, now they are.
Somebody at Nintendo headquarters is like, guys, I don't know if we should do this.
It was fine before, but not now. For whatever reason.
Somebody left Miyamoto alone in her room. They're like, Miyamoto-san, no. I always hit the capture button on this controller. Sell. I don't need that. Okay. What's this? Oh, my Kinsect. Okay. That I'll never use.
Just tell me what... Yeah, I haven't used that either.
So what can I help you with?
I would like to upgrade all my things. Thank you. Okay.
Excellent.
All my armor spheres. I'm starting to look less like Shredder.
Just tell me what you need.
And where's my hammer? Can I upgrade it yet? No? Ugh. Fine.
Thank you, kind.
Hate to defend anybody.
You have to kill a cow lady in Undertale? What?
How is that defending Nintendo?
Yeah.
I mean, you ever play It Takes Two? There's a real sad part in that game. I don't want to spoil it, but I'm gonna now. Where there's a stuffed elephant that just wants to be your friend, and somehow the characters decide if they kill the stuffed elephant, they'll turn back into real people. And then they kill the elephant in the saddest way possible, and then they don't turn back. So you killed that elephant for no reason, and me, like, Tina was about to cry.
Oh.
It's so sad. I'm out to craft. I would like all of them.
Have you seen that Pixar movie, Inside Something?
Oh, Inside Out? Yeah. Also sad.
Yeah, do you see that imaginary friend that sacrificed himself to save them?
Yeah, it was really sad.
That was super sad.
That was so sad.
Yeah.
Some cartoons just get to me.
Mm-hmm.
Manage items. Let's... Oh, my item pouch should be empty. Auto sort. What are these? Herbal medicine. Removes all the traces of poison. I guess that's useful. Oh, I do have traps. Okay. Neat. All this ammo that I'll never use.
I never played Undertale because, again, the community.
Oh, yeah. No, that's
super
one.
Super toxic. Yeah.
Yeah. What else are you going to do? So, I mean, I don't know much about Undertale, Chaz, but I know that the whole point of that game is to not fight. Like, that was the main lesson of the game.
Well, that's one way of playing it. You don't have to do pacifist.
Oh, I thought that was, like, the whole thing the game was trying to teach you. Maybe I'm wrong, then.
Maybe. I just heard that that's one way to play it. I don't know if that was the way to play it.
Hmm. Oh, I missed the quest. Let's kill Arathian. Blair Witch VR edition? No thanks, dude.
Oh no.
No spoilers. Carl, the game's been out since like... Hold on. I'm feeling really sorry, we didn't mean to spoil it, but you had 7 years. You had time, my guy. I mean, there's so many things going on in that game, you could play it.
Yeah, that's not really a spoiler. It's just that's just one way of playing it. You could play it as a pacifist or not. So that's not really a spoiler.
Oh, not that game. What game did I spoil it?
What?
I don't know. Apparently I spoiled something.
Oh.
I don't know. Special edition. 5 minutes of free. Oh, UFC.
Oh, yeah, Kev, you had to do your urgent quest. I think it might have popped up already for you.
Oh, maybe I missed it. All right, we'll get to it. My bad. Oh, yeah, that's the one to move on. Okay. Yeah. Oh, UFC, Carl. Oh, I see. Okay. I thought I spelled Undertale. I was about to be like, you had time.
Yeah, you noticed that, like, people are pissed about, like, Final Fantasy VII being spoiled. It's like,
yeah,
you've had a while.
I mean, I get, like, if it's a brand new release, like, in the remake, maybe. But, like, I remember when that game got ported to, like, the Steam version came to PS4. And people were like, don't spoil it. I'm like, dude, it's you're late. Sorry. I think, like, 2 months is an appropriate time for spoilers. Like, you can't get mad if, like, if you're playing it, just ask people. But, like, I can't assume at that point. Mm-hmm. Where are we? Do we have to go to the top left? Also, how is Stitch flying? What the fuck? How did you do that?
Stitch is flying.
He's a wizard. All right. Come in. Yeah, you had decades to figure out about Final Fantasy VII. I can't help you at that point. I don't know if you guys saw this movie, what's the one? Sixth Sense with Bruce Willis? Bro, listen, I got a spoiler for you.
Oh yeah, people do that. If you ever reference that movie in the ending, they're like, you're spoiling!
I mean, that's like the most famous spoiler in movies, I think. Mm. And in games, I think like the Final Fantasy stuff. I think everyone knows it by this point. If you don't, you must have just been born. Sorry.
See, I'm someone that doesn't really care about spoilers because I feel like when I experience it, then that's just different than because someone said it. You know what I mean? Like, I just find it. But most people don't agree with that. So
I mean, if I'm watching a stream and then I get mad at, well, I'm not going to be. But if somebody gets mad that, like, I can't believe you spoiled it. I'm like, dude, you're watching a stream. What the fuck did you want?
Like, exactly. Like,
that's like your fault.
Internet. And I was like, well, then don't be on social media when something comes out that you want to see or play. Then I don't know.
Chaz, we're not gonna spoil it for you. Actually, you know what? I will, because I'm not gonna back down on my point. Bruce is dead. And if you watch the movie, you'll notice he never has a shadow in the movie either.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. So, there's that. And if that's a spoiler, too bad, you had time.
Well, actually, that adds replay value, because you want to watch the movie again to see all the clues that you missed, or...
Yeah.
Like, oh, that's that under... No, that makes sense, that now that I know...
It's like if I come across a spoiler on my own terms, I'm fine with it. But like, if somebody's going out of their way to tell me, then I'm annoyed. Like if I'm on the internet and I just happen to see, I'm like, ah, darn, okay. Or if I'm watching a stream. But if like one of my friends comes up and like, hey, just so you know, Aerith dies, I'm like, yo, fuck you. Oops, spoil Final Fantasy. You'll be okay.
Well, did you see the post-credit scene for Black Adam?
No. A movie, John? Come on.
So I'll stay quiet then. Unless I spoil you.
For everyone else, because it just came out. Maybe for that one.
Okay. Yeah. But anyway, it was all over social media. Like, people were, like, in the movie theater. Like, filming.
Oh, yeah.
Saying, hey, look! It's like, oh, that was great. Thanks.
The only one I didn't see either Sonic movie, but when people like, you'll never guess who's in the post-credits. I'm like, is it Knuckles? Because it's a Sonic movie, and that's pretty much all you got. And then it was Knuckles, and then the second movie, they're like, you'll never guess. I'm like, it's Shadow. Like, it's Sonic, guys. Like, I know there's not that much going on here. It's just Sonic. Who's left? The fucking Rouge the Bat? I don't know.
Well, who would be in the post-credit scene for the Mario movie? That's what I wonder.
Wario or Waluigi, probably.
Yes.
And if Waluigi's in the Mario movie, I just won't see it. Because fuck Waluigi. Mm. There's super villain movie shows.
No, it'd be really funny if Wario just doesn't have a voice. He just goes, wah ha 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 ha.
No, then people would complain about it. And you know what? Here's the thing. I hate post-credit scenes. Listen, I saw the credits. I'm ready to go home after 2 hours. I don't want to stay for another 5 minutes for somebody's butt to be shown on screen. Everyone goes, this butt, it's confirmed. Like,
I think it's just a way to get you to stay to watch all the credits.
It's not like there's ad revenue. What are you making me stay for?
But it works, you know?
Yeah, people love it.
But now people expect a post-credit scene, and when there's not, people get angry.
It's like when I go to a concert and the band goes, "All right, we're walking off stage now. We're definitely not going to play another song." And then I'm like, "We all know you're going to do it." And they're like, "What? An encore? What? Okay, I guess we will." I'm like, "You didn't even turn the lights on, guys." Like,
I heard somebody say that they were scared of doing that because, like, what if I come back for the encore and everybody left?
I mean, it's just like, if you don't turn the arena lights on, I know what you're going to do. And me being me, I'm like, even a band I like, I went to see A Day to Remember, and they did their encore thing. I was like, okay, one more song. They were like, we'll do four more songs. I'm like, okay, well, I'm tired now, guys. Like, let's not.
Chaz, there's a current trend that I don't necessarily agree with, but doing the anti-hero, like Morbius, they're doing Kraven, they did Venom. So there's a new trend where we're going to make you sympathize with the villain. So, yeah, Black Adam is supposed to be a villain, but he's an anti-hero in this one.
Yoshi, two theories have flooded Reddit. The movie's either a prequel to Mario Bros. 3 or Mario RPG. Why would they jump to Mario 3?
I am curious on what it looks like it's based on. Like what modern Mario games? Is it based on Mario 3? Is Yoshi in it? We don't know if Yoshi's in it.
I'm going to be real with you. I don't think it's gonna connect to any game.
I'm just curious on what they do. I really hope that there is an island that he goes to full of Yoshis. Like, I want that.
Yeah.
Maybe Yoshi's a post-credit scene.
Maybe, I don't know.
It's like Super Mario Galaxy 2. It's like, it's the same game, but with Yoshi!
Yeah, I gotta play Mario Galaxy 2. I wanna see how different it is, or not different.
I'm in the minority, I guess, but I felt like it was pretty much the same game, but with Yoshi.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm just going to take the Mario movie for what it is, and it's probably going to be okay.
Yeah, and I think it's going to be good. It's going to entertain. That's his job. It's going to be entertaining.
Yes. It's based on the lava coming down the Koopa Castle. All right, you know what? Here's my hot take on that, Chaz. I think people look way too into Nintendo stuff, and they just kind of just do it because.
Mario like with lore. Isn't that funny?
Mario lore, Zelda lore. What? I think y'all got to take that at face value. Like,
Well, at least Zelda, some the games have a plot and a story, whereas Mario games never really had a plot other than rescue the princess, you know?
Yeah, I know.
Even in games like Mario Galaxy, I mean Odyssey, or even like the, you know, the console games, it's just same plot, rescue the princess.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, I just take every Nintendo game at face value. I'm not looking for a lore thread. Blah, blah, blah.
But I think it works that way. I kind of don't want my Mario games to have a complicated story. It doesn't need to.
Chris Pratt's fine. I'm doubling down. That I want Mario's voice just to be Chris Pratt now all the time.
Well, what I don't like is that people are just going too extreme with it. Like, was the voice great? No, but yeah. I'm gonna give it a chance. Like, we only got two lines, so let's just wait and see. But people love jumping to conclusions and judgment, and you don't know yet.
Yeah, I don't know. Probably be fine. Well, you know, my theory is halfway through the movie he's gonna become Super Mario. And then his voice is going to start going woo, woo, all the time. Like, you know, like once he gets his Mario power, there's probably going to be some dumb lore power thing.
Well, to have a movie, to have people watch a movie for 2 hours, I feel like a voice has to be relatable or at least listenable. You know what I mean? I don't think people understand that.
Yeah. It's just his regular voice. Good.
Also, this is not going to be just for Nintendo fans. You know, if you want this movie to make money, it has to be a general audience thing as well.
Did anyone bitch at Sonic's voice?
No. See, that's true. But the thing is, Sonic never really had a voice. Well, he did, I guess.
Yeah, he does have a voice.
In the 3D games, he had a voice. But it actually wasn't that far off from the movie, I think.
Expedition Tour. I don't see my urgent quest. I don't see an urgent quest.
There should be. Yeah, wait, go back to level 2.
I don't see anything.
Yeah, I guess you don't. That's weird.
Do I have to do all the dumb stuff?
All the red ones. You did all the red ones.
Yeah. Yeah, I have to do, like, these dumb things.
All right.
Well, I guess we'll do the dumb things. Hide. So a total of 20 Jagras and Ludroth. Okay. Well, I guess we'll just do it. Whatever. Maybe it'll come up after I do this. Who knows? Did I eat? I did not eat. Eat a meal. Oh, I did eat. Never mind. Depart. Oh, I need to talk to the fat guy. Oh.
You didn't talk to the fat guy.
Oh. Should I exit this quest then?
No, we could still do it.
Okay.
This is a quick one. You have to kill the little monsters.
They didn't do anything to hurt anybody.
Listen up!
Can't relate to this when I grew up with Captain Al Walker Boone.
Well, you can't say that. You haven't seen his version yet. Again, judging two lines. I don't know. I'm not that judgmental, I guess.
I'm also in that. I'm in the camp that maybe Charles Martin Age is old and wants to not do that. Like,
from what I heard, yeah, they did offer to him and he said no. We don't know if that's true.
Yeah, I mean.
Nintendo's fine with this and the movie studio's fine with this, then why don't we have faith in that until we see it? You know what I mean? I don't know.
If this wasn't Mario, I don't think anyone would give a shit. I'm going to be honest. Like, okay, how come nobody complained that Ryan Reynolds is fucking Pikachu? Like, I don't remember hearing that conversation. Pikachu. That's not my Pikachu. He's supposed to sound like Pika Pika. Like, yeah, I don't know. I think people are just a little too attached to something for no reason. Like, characters evolve, man. I can't get behind it.
Yeah.
Gonna be all right. And also, like, I mean, like, the whole cast is weird. Like, Seth Rogen is, well, who's he? Bowser? Donkey Kong.
Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. Why are people complaining just about Chris Pratt? All the voice options, all the voices are going to be strange because we're not used to them sounding like that. So they're all going to be weird. But I think during the course of the movie, it's going to work. You know, once our ears get used to hearing these characters we've always known not sound that way, eventually we'll get used to it.
I think people just, it's one of those things I think people just get over. Well, Pikachu's just Pika Pika. Tell me all of Mario's famous monologues in his games. Like, he says Wahoo in Let's A Go.
Yeah, I guess people wanted that for 2 hours.
I'm good. I wanted a re-edited director's cut of the movie where that's all Mario says.
And people be like, this is the real version of the movie.
You know, some guy on YouTube's gonna do that. Like, I would love for that, actually. Mario, quick, the princess, let's go! Yeah, Mario, I know, Mario.
He just says, let's go for 2 hours.
I do like Charlie Day, though, so anything Charlie Day does, I'm in. That's funny.
I think he's gonna be a good Luigi. I don't know how that's gonna work, but I think he's gonna be good.
That guy's magic. He can make anything work.
Because Luigi's going to be screaming in fear for 2 hours.
I would rather have seen a Luigi's Mansion movie than a Mario movie.
I agree. But you know what's weird is Luigi's Mansion is not that popular. I'm surprised that Mansion 3, a lot of people skipped out on that. And I don't get it. That was my game. That was my game of the year. And a lot of people are just like playing it now or never played it.
Yeah, that's
up there with Odyssey. Like, I think it's a AAA Nintendo game, and yet a lot of people skipped it.
I gotta play Odyssey again too. I love that game.
I'm still pissed we didn't get any DLC. That game just made me want more.
Wasn't there a weird, like, mini-game DLC, like a balloon thing or something, I remember?
Luigi's Balloon World. Yeah, that doesn't count.
Well, why is it, why not Tingle?
Yes.
We need Tingle's Balloon World. Tingle gets arrested and is put on a registry.
Yes.
That's let's be real. That's what Tingle's going to do.
Tingle gets arrested should be a game.
Mansion 3 is better than Odyssey. Ooh, hot take.
I like both games. I don't know. Yeah,
they're very different.
One more than the other.
They're so different. I don't know if I can compare them like that. But I mean.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. They're both good. My little brother has my copy of Mansion 3, and I know I'll get that back.
Hmm.
He just wants my AV cable for my GameCube. That's lame. Okay. I might have him. Do I even have a GameCube AV cable anymore?
Give him the component cable that's worth hundreds of dollars.
Oh, I might have a better idea. I might just give him a link to this. Or the HDMI thing.
Yeah, there's cables for it from who?
There's like a generic one. Hyperkin probably makes one.
Yeah.
I forget that it works on N64. I haven't owned any Luigi's Mansion games. I looked at 30 minutes of Dark Moon. You're missing out. You should play all the Luigi's Mansions.
I think you would like them, Stitch. They're all good. But yeah, I'm surprised how many people have skipped the whole franchise. And they're really good games.
They're really good. Alright, let's see. I got all this stuff. Alright, so we gotta talk to our fat man.
Mm-hmm.
Just fat. Just don't wanna play it, just other things coming out. Yeah. Listen, I've now categorized myself as a retro game appreciator. Like, there's just too many good new games now.
That's what I don't understand. When you, like, haven't played a game, people assume you hate it. And it's like, no, if it came out when a game that I really wanted came out, then I just didn't get to it or it wasn't on my radar. That doesn't mean you hate it just because you skipped it. But that seems to be the mentality of the internet.
Well, you can only go to the top shelf on the internet. Order the usual. Okay, I got my urgent thing. I thought they were going to remake the first one, Porter or something. Maybe. I remember they did on 3DS, but they should delve more into the 3DS library for the Switch.
Well, there was a whole series of games that they put out with the 3DS when the Switch was out, which was a huge mistake.
Sushi Striker.
Not that one. The Luigi's Mansion port should have been on Switch. Samus Returns should have been on Switch. What was it? Wario. WarioWare should have been on Switch.
The 100 one.
There was a whole bunch of them that they released that a lot of people skipped because it's like, I'm over the 3DS. Like,
there was the WarioWare that came out on Switch. Was that any good?
No, it was very disappointing. I was very hyped for it. I'm a fan of the whole WarioWare series, but you could beat that game in like 2 hours.
Lame.
And it has no replay value.
I think WarioWare is a time and place thing, man. I don't think we're ever going to come back to that.
No, the problem is WarioWare Gold on the 3DS was amazing. There was tons of content. The thing is, there was hardly any content on the Switch version. And you don't even unlock anything. Where WarioWare, you always unlock stuff. So I don't understand why it was so bare bones. It seems like they just rushed it out.
That's when sometimes I don't know, man.
That's what I'm saying, inconsistency. Like, you don't expect it to be like that. And then this is how it is. They cheapened out.
There's a bunch of stuff on 3DS I want to come back. It's like, you can't play it on a TV.
That's what I'm saying. They should have come out with a 3DS player, either for the Wii U or the Switch. Just let us play our 3DS games on a TV.
Yeah. All right. Guy bought an HDMI cord for the GameCube instead. Smart move, Alex.
Yeah, I think if you were just to buy the HDMI cable for the GameCube, I think you might get the same quality as an AV, but at least you get to use it on a modern TV.
Yeah. This TV I bought down here doesn't even have AV on it.
Like, it's not, I don't think it's going to upscale it, but I don't know.
It's a little cleaner. The dead beckon.
atop their pyre.
Volcano hype.
Let's kill it.
This is your first time in this map, right?
I believe so.
Hype, hype. This map is super confusing.
That's like, not good.
Yeah, like if it shows you like an area, you're like, wait, is that underground or is that above ground? And how do I get there? So even I'm still confused on this map. So just to keep in mind.
All right. Stitch, guide us. Guide Amaterasu.
Oh, yeah. Okay. This one they have an amiibo for. This is the one.
Oh, this monster?
Yeah, this was kind of their flagship or their iconic monster of this game.
They also made a collection of Game Watch game for the 3DS. They have Game Watch gallery collections in the 3DS? I remember them on Game Boy.
I desperately want another Game & Watch, and Nintendo just is ignoring it. But Game & Watch 4 for the Game Boy was amazing. It had like every Game & Watch game. And
I only had the first one.
They made two of them for the DS, but those were Club Nintendo exclusives. They never did a Game & Watch. And I'm like, what? Just make a collection. Just put it out there.
Where's NES Remix on Switch?
That's another thing. Why did they let that die? That was an IP. That was a franchise.
That was such a good idea.
People were like, where's Super Nintendo Remix?
Yeah.
They never did it.
Yeah, you know what? That's a big... Why didn't they do that?
That is a huge IP that would sell millions, and they just...
Carl, make notes. Bring this to your superiors.
I don't get it. So that's just decisions of Nintendo just not doing certain things that would make a lot of money. And like, you know, they want money. So why don't they do this? I'm confused.
Maybe they're just like quieter about like old games like PlayStation. PlayStation is a lot about it. They're just like, you don't want to play old games. We just want you to think about old games.
Sony is worse with that. But I do think that there are times where Nintendo is just, it doesn't get the nostalgia thing enough. In my opinion.
You must wait until 20 years when nobody cares about it. Then we'll re-release it. It's the perfect time for Win Back.
But hey, to be fair, I never knew Win Back existed until it appeared on Switch. And that's actually a pretty good game. So.
I have not tried the PS2 version, but I remember on N64, it was pretty okay.
Did we play the multiplayer on the Switch version? We should do that.
I'm not against it. Oh, God, I fell all the way down the map.
Okay. No.
Yeah, I'm never getting back up. All right, guys, have fun with that.
Is what I meant about getting lost. It's just kind of...
Oh, the monster's going to that area. Okay.
Hey, Stitch is putting a signal saying, go here, here.
I'm trying, Stitch.
Yeah, I'm above. I'm just trying to get down. But I don't know... Oh, I think I found it.
Yeah. Now I have so many games I'm thinking about now that I want to play. Wait, what's this monster? Oh, is this one we're fighting? It's this guy. Okay.
Yep. Now, be careful. He can kill you instantly with one hit.
What?
Yeah, like he starts glowing purple. He'll jump in the air and then shoot down like a meteor and he'll kill you.
That seems unfair. The fuck? It's like going into an MMA fight, guys. Like, by the way, I brought a gun, just so you know. They said I could.
Oh, bitch killed it.
Is it dead? No, it's not.
No.
Let's say, geez, that was fast.
He's sleepy.
Can you find an article on that? Because I've never heard that before, Chaz.
Each game full ROMs? Really? That's interesting.
And also, man, Nintendo's a little late on that, if that's what they're worried about. They found the purple.
No, but like, there was a lot of untapped potential there. They could have made an NES Remix 3. They could have made a Super Nintendo Remix. They could have done an N64 Remix. They could have made a Game Boy Remix. Like, there's a whole franchise right there.
I would have liked Remix Maker.
That would have been cool.
They should really do Mario Maker 3, but this time, like, make a PC, like, companion thing to be like, listen, you can design the labels here. Or the levels, like, because doing it on the Switch, I think, killed that game.
Yeah, unfortunately, they just kind of put it out to die, and I don't get it.
Like, the Wii U tablet's perfect for that, but, like, maybe if you, like, design it on a browser, and then like we'll import it for you. Something like that. Ooh. Or you can play in the 3DS where you can't search levels. Lol.
That was an unnecessary release.
What could you just make levels and that was it on that one?
You can make levels and then you could trade them locally.
Wow.
But not cool. There was no online.
Why does Nintendo hate the internet?
Well, actually, you could play. I think you could play selected Wii U levels online on the 3DS one, but you couldn't upload any levels. So it's weird. Like you could do this, but not this. It's like, oh.
I have so many questions about this company sometimes. Very strange birds. Magna Marlo. Let's kill it. I got all the stuff from it. I hope I can get a cool new weapon at least. That'd be neat. What was that goal thing? I just updated my little Twitch goal. You can do that from the dashboard now.
Goal thing, Kev.
They call me the goaltender. Because I make your goal tender.
Huh?
I don't know what I was going for with that.
Oh, I forgot to do this.
Very good. Yeah, end of the month is coming. I didn't realize, like, we're almost in November, bro. Infinite Glizzy. Ugh. I don't like calling this a hot dog a Glizzy. It just seems weird.
Where did that come from?
I don't know.
That until recently.
I wish I can give you an answer.
I call it a hot dog.
It's a hot dog.
Okay.
What do you call long sandwiches? I'm sure in New York we call it the same thing.
Is a hot dog a sandwich?
Yes.
It's meat and bread, so.
Well, do you call it a sub or a grinder? Which one would you call, like the big long sandwich, do you call that a sub or a grinder?
I never heard it referred to as that.
What do you call it then? Not a hot dog. No, not a hot dog. Like a big, yeah, a big sandwich. Call it a sub, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So no sometimes
matter, no
call
matter,
a grinder.
No matter the size, you can just call it a sub.
Well, a long phallic sandwich, I guess. I don't know what you'd call it.
Well, you call it a 6-inch or a 12-inch, you still call it a sub.
Yeah, I mean, one deli by me calls them grinders, and I can live with that.
That is a gay app.
Yeah, but like a grinder sandwich, you never heard that before?
No, I've never heard that.
The deli I go to says they're like a New York-style deli, so are you telling me they're liars?
I've never heard it referred to as that, and I'm in New York.
I'm gonna go up to him and be like, I heard you guys were phonies. Narga Kuga. I wanna kill those. That armor looks cool. Yo, we need to kill a Narga Kuga. This armor looks sick. I will never call it a hoagie, ever.
Hoagies. That's a good name.
I don't like that name at all. I do not like hoagie. Hoagie sounds like a dance that like some church thought was for the devil. Our kids are out there doing the hoagie. I don't like that. Alright, I want to kill a Narga Kuga, because I want that armor real bad.
How can I help you?
How do I fight it, though? Uh-huh. Oh. Is Kev back? Yeah, I'm back. Don't worry about me.
Hello.
Alright, how do we find... I need to do that immediately. Narga Kuga, I'm in. Yeah, I don't like hoagie. I've definitely heard grinder before, though. Oh, here's another. When it comes to tacos, soft shell or hard shell?
I like both, but I prefer a hard shell.
I'm a soft shell guy. I've heard the real trick is to eat it in a hard shell with a soft shell below you, like catching all your debris, and then you have a second taco.
We talked about this.
Did we? Yeah.
Taco Bell, they take a soft shell, they melt cheese on it, and then they wrap a hard shell around it.
Oh, I've done that before.
It's really good.
Let's see.
It's like, why not both?
That girl's a hero. Soft shell flour. Yes, flour, tortilla, all day.
That's not traditionally Mexican.
You think I'm going here for traditional? I want a taco.
They gotta be traditional at Taco Bell.
I mean, yeah. It's like Olive Garden, my authentic Italian food.
I love Olive Garden. I don't know why it gets hate.
It gets hate for no reason. Like, listen, I don't care how authentic it is. I just want it.
It's like, why do people need their food authentic? Just eat it.
I don't know. People are weird. Mm-hmm. Alright, I need... There's a sonic bomb. Sonic boom. Sonic boom. Mm-hmm. Where is this monster?
Oh, how to use a sonic bomb, it never works for me. So maybe...
Yeah. Maybe it's for little monsters, but...
I use the flash bomb. That always works. So
I'm too strong. Too strong for them. And Stitch is just murdering all the animals.
PETA does not like Stitch.
Yeah, Stitch. We're going to send PETA after you. Give me the Narcoguga. I want this armor so bad. It looks so cool. If you guys wouldn't mind fighting it a couple times, that'd be great. I haven't had to sharpen my fucking hammer in a while either.
There you go.
Such a dumb thing. I really just wish I thought of something for the hammer, but like, nope, whetstone.
You gotta sharpen that hammer.
Well, we're in at work. I'm like, yeah, let me sharpen this real quick. That's the good stuff. How do I change what my guy says?
There is a setting for that.
Seems like one of those settings I'll probably never go to other than once.
Riding hype.
Oh, sick. I'm gonna like think I'm so good at Monster Hunter, then I'm gonna go to single player and be like, hey guys, give me help.
Yeah, I would like to see you play single player, see how you handle all this.
On the list, trust me. I know how to play Monster Hunter. I was good at World. I only needed help on the final mission. That was really it. I streamed a little bit of World. That was back when I was at my parents'.
No, it was, did you play on PS4?
Yes.
If you start over on Xbox, I'll join you.
If it goes back on Game Pass, I will. I ain't buying it again.
Oh.
We can do Dauntless.
I like Dauntless. You didn't.
I didn't hate it. It was another situation of like, well, I'll just play Monster Hunter. But now I'm a little more open.
It's Monster Hunter free to play.
I mean, yeah, it kind of is, right? What do you have to pay for?
I think it's just cosmetic things. You don't need to pay to play Dauntless.
No, then yeah, we'll do that. Maybe. I got Rise first, and then I'll make my... Maybe I'll whip out the 3DS one.
I used to play Dauntless with Rick when he played games.
Hey, listen, according to him, he played Sheds this week.
Shed Building Simulator.
I would love to, like, get those Swedish developers and be like, listen, this is my friend Rick. He builds sheds. Can you guys do something with him? Make all these other sim games. Why not? Give me all your parts.
That doesn't sound right.
I know what I said. Standing by it. Whoa. Yay! Alright, I might have to kill this a couple of times because I want the armor set. It's so pretty and purple.
You could do that off stream on your...
Fine. Does anyone ever play Call of Juarez?
Huh?
Call of Juarez?
I think I've heard of it.
It's $1.99 on the eShop right now, in case you care.
Mm-hmm. Oh, did you see, what was it? Zombie Ate My Neighbors is like $7.50 right now.
If only we could play it online.
Yeah, I still don't want to get it. Doesn't matter what the price is, it's not online.
So. It all comes with Ghoul Patrol. Heard it's pretty good. Yeah, Call of Juarez, I heard it's pretty good. My friend used to like the first one. Oh man. Let's see. I'm trying to find more fun deals. Yeah, Zombies Ate My Neighbors, no online. Don't know why.
Yeah, it would have been an insta buy. It doesn't matter what price it was. I would have bought it if it had online. Now, if they sold it for $1, I wouldn't buy it because it just doesn't have online.
Yeah, I mean, listen, Chaz, it's still worth it.
Play the ROM. You know, it's just ugh.
You would play. You would never play the ROM. That's You would play your official backup.
Like if online's a deal breaker for you, don't get it.
I did it, and it's worth it to me.
If you have people to play locally, then it's worth it.
I'm gonna play by myself and win. All right, what do we got? Still got my SNES copy. Well, if you got your Super Nintendo copy, sell that bitch.
Money.
Yeah. The only Super Nintendo games I really I got Jurassic Park and a multi-cart. So I have like 400 games essentially is what I'm trying to say.
There you go.
So what can I help you with?
I would like my armor. Forge armor. Damn it, I can only make the pants.
Excellent. Oh.
Alright, fine. Oh, I could have made the helmet. Shit, never mind. Whatever, these pants are cool. It's got frillies on it.
What can I help you with?
And I can upgrade my pants, at least.
Piece of cake.
Hell yeah. Can I do anything to my hammer yet? Survey said... Nope. God, it really doesn't want me to upgrade this hammer. Well, right. Fair. Alright. Let's keep killing stuff. So, wait. If I go up 100 rank every time we pass the stars, how did you guys get to 200?
You unlock the cap after a while.
Oh, okay. And then does it just go really fast after that?
Sort of.
Okay. Somnikanth. Could I ask you a favor? Sure. What do you want? It's beautiful, of course, and I'd like to meet you if you please pick paper apart. Request. Yeah, whatever. I'll do a request when I feel like it.
Later.
All right. I would like my meals, please. Here are the points. Give me the usual. Remember my mom bought Zombie. She enjoyed the version on the Sega channel. So fun fact, you can't beat the Genesis version of that game.
I heard something about that.
Yeah, it's just broken. But I like the Genesis version because the map is always on the side of the screen, not interfering. But yeah, can't beat that version.
Hmm.
I wonder if they ever patch it. Like on the Antstream, you could play both versions. Wait, is Antstream have online? I don't remember.
I don't think so.
Oh man, because then we could play it.
Well, if Fightcade worked for you, we could have.
I should go back to that and see if it works again. All right, let's see. Supply box. One NOG drink, please.
NOG.
Yeah, it's my favorite brand. Nondescript gamer fuel. I heard gamer subs is pretty good. I might try looking into that, but I ordered Mega Man first because I gotta try.
It's good.
Oh,
yeah, I guess if you have a Genesis Game Genie, you could. Do it.
Yes, then you can. But I don't think you can beat it any other way. But like still, if you have to cheat to make the game work, I don't think your game works.
Well, it's like Battletoads, it's not beatable two players because there's some glitch in one of the later levels.
One day they'll make a good Battletoads game.
I like Battletoads. I think people just like it because it's hard, though, but I like Battletoads.
Maybe the sequels is better.
The arcade one is really good. Have you played the arcade one?
I don't think I have. You know what?
All right, that's a good one. I think you would like that one.
Is that on Rare Replay?
It is.
Maybe I'll try that one, then.
There you go.
But, like, NES Battletoads, I was never, like, thrilled with it. Genesis one I thought was okay.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's still got the two-player issues that the NES one had.
I don't think so.
Oh, well, what are we doing then? Play it on Game Boy.
The Game Boy one is rough.
Oh, is it? I thought it would be like... They should make a Battletoads collection. Ah, man, we just got a new Battletoads. Come on.
Oh, and it was... well, Rare Replay is pretty much the Battletoads collection.
Yeah, that's true. It's like when they're talking about making like a Gears like collection, like Halo. I'm like, they're just on Game Pass, man. We might as well just go play them all there. I don't know. I mean, like, if they're already in something, I don't think we need... like, are they going to remaster and redo the lore?
Lore.
And then you can play as Battletoads in Killer Instinct.
Yeah.
If you really hate yourself. I kind of want to play that with people, because that game's really fun.
You should play. I've never played the recent Battle... Killer Instinct, so we should play.
The single player is weird. There's, like, a story mode, but, like... some characters have a story, some don't, and then there's something called, like, Shadow Masters, and, like, that's, like, a weird thing. I just want to play arcade mode, man. Why do they gotta make fighting games weird? Just, like, let me just play arcade.
Well done.
Launch monster? I would love to. Oh, launch off the monster. That's what it looks like. Oh, there's two of them. Is it as good as a SNES Killer Instinct? It's got a different feel to it. It's a little more friendly to, like, do crazy combos. So, it depends if you like that or not.
See, I didn't know this, but apparently the arcade Killer Instinct is really hard to emulate, but it plays really well on Rare Replay.
Oh, yeah, if they got I guess if the developers got to figure it out.
Yeah, but unfortunately, no multiplayer... Or no online. I think, yeah, just local, but no online with Rare Replay, which I think was a huge mistake. I don't get that.
Me either. I don't know. Killer Instinct, the new one, it's different, but it's fun. I'll say that, Jazz. It's definitely got a different feel to it. Undefeated against monsters.
I beat Kev in Killer Instinct in Retro World.
Yeah, I'm just not good on arcade sticks. I'm a controller boy. It's what it is. I'm also just bad at games.
I was just smashing buttons.
I mean, that's how you play Killer Instinct. In the new one, they have something called Combo Assist, where if you're just essentially hitting forward and one of the attack buttons, it'll just do crazy combos, like, easier for you.
What was that game where you're fighting dinosaurs? It's like a fighting game.
Bloody Roar?
Primal something.
Oh, Primal Rage? Oh, yeah!
Yeah, Primal Rage, like, I don't know, that would be fun. I wish that was online.
That, it's on one of the Midway collections for, like, PS2 and GameCube and stuff.
Mm.
It's really fun. Wait, do I have that? I remember renting that as a kid, too.
It's probably on Fightcade. Too bad.
It's better than Clay Fighter, that's for sure.
Wasn't there a problem with the new Killer Instinct that it was really bare bones, and then they kept, like, you have to pay more to get characters and stuff?
So it came out as a free-to-play fighting game like that, and then eventually they were just like, alright, we're done with this.
Wow.
And you can just buy it straight up. When it came to Game Pass, they're like, alright, guys. Primal Rage is on Midway Arcade Treasures 2, which I do have. I like that, and I played the arcade version.
I like that the health bar looks like veins and a heart beating, and then when you beat it, beat the person, the heart explodes.
Because that's, you gotta be violent in the 90s, bro.
Yeah.
Mortal Kombat only. That's why we were getting a new Mortal Kombat mobile RPG.
That's gonna be weird.
Definitely gonna be weird. Oh god. I think I found the Ocarina of Time Master Quest sealed at a Goodwill. God damn it, I can't be that lucky.
There was a time where you could do that. That's really rare that you could do that now.
I haven't checked a Goodwill in so long.
But yeah, that's a good place, because people do get rid of things that they don't know the value of. Like, someone's grandma takes your stuff from the attic, and it's like, oh, he doesn't play these anymore.
I keep telling Rick to call me when he gets stuff there. Hmm. They made Primal Rage toys, really?
Ooh, I want them. They need to re-release those.
I want that. I guess I'll upgrade my thingies. These are the ones I'm wearing. Okay. Confirm. Confirm. You have the... Okay, apparently Stitch had him too. I just remember the gorilla with the blue chest. Forget his name. I don't remember any of the characters' names, but I remember the raptor being cool. I've been waiting for
you. I think they released a Game Boy version of that too.
Why?
Hunt a Gossparag. I wish you luck. Sitch, have you gotten pictures of these? I need to see them.
Well, Primal Rage was made by Atari.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
It was on Arcade, 3DO, 32X.
It was a 3DO? Oh, God.
Yes. Atari Jaguar CD, Game Boy, Game Gear, PlayStation, Sega Genesis, Sega Saturn, Super Nintendo. Wow, they put it on everything.
Weird.
That's cool, but yeah, a lot of ports.
Huh.
Yeah, it was on the Sega Channel.
Wow.
I'm sure Chaz played it.
The Sega Channel, the best way to play anything.
Mm.
I mean, it was kind of cool. It was ahead of its day, for sure. You have to play in the arcade mode with a skating rink. We had a skating rink, and it had such a good arcade. It had Popeye. It had Revolution X, you know.
You left before I joined.
Oh, I did. Oh, no.
I can still join.
So. Oh, you can't? Okay, sorry.
I remember Monster Hunter when you couldn't.
Yeah, I really appreciate their quality of life stuff they've done.
Mm-hmm.
What else did I have? Revolution X is still a weird game, but also Steven Tyler is a weird guy, and Aerosmith needs to go away forever.
Revolution X is a very bizarre game.
Have you ever heard how weird Steven Tyler is?
He seems weird, but no, I haven't.
He somehow convinced a 14-year-old to, one, marry him, and two, got permission from her parents.
Well, yeah, that was a payday, I'm sure.
Who just hands their 14-year-old off to be like, yeah, go marry this fucking coke-addicted rock star?
When Michael Jackson, parents were just giving their children to him.
I don't understand. Like, is it being starstruck? What the fuck is wrong with people?
It's just about money. I mean, you know, people are willing to sacrifice their children for money. It's fucked up, but that's the way it is.
Jesus. I don't know. Yeah, Steven Tyler is a weird guy that we should never allow to be a thing.
Well, but the whole series of musicians that marry young, I mean, I think Elvis Presley was with Priscilla when she was 14. Jerry Lee Lewis, same thing, was with his cousin when she was like 14.
Oh, it was his cousin, so you know, they knew each other. What the fuck? Yeah,
that's what happens.
I don't know, that shit's so weird to me, but... Escargot? A large green snail sprays restorative mist when used. Oh, okay. Oh, Escargot. Yeah.
Get it?
I get what they're going for.
Yeah, if you put down that thing, he'll just start spraying healing on that spot for a while, and that's good.
You know what we really need a remake of? Bushido Blade.
I don't know what that is.
It is a Square Enix fighting game with sword fighting.
But we know how Square Enix thinks about old games.
Well, so the gimmick of it was there's no life bars.
Oh.
So you had to strike a fatal blow to kill anybody. What did my little brother say? Oh boy. Balls of Fire still hold up this good movie. I didn't even know that was a movie.
That was
Balls of Fire.
I think that was with Dennis Quaid. It came out in the 90s.
I only know of Balls of Fury.
Oh.
Did you ever see that movie? The ping pong movie with Christopher Walken?
I've heard of it. I have not seen it.
It's got a great Wii game.
Oh.
And by great, I mean it's got a Wii game. Do you remember when Rockstar Table Tennis was like a game that people were really excited about?
No.
It was like a weird 360 like launch-ish game, and it was just table tennis made by Rockstar. It was very weird. But people love that game. Yeah. Oh man. Who's on it? Oh, John's on it. I get Dennis Quaid and Bruce Willis mixed up a lot, too. They're like the same actor, right?
I never got them mixed up, but I can see why.
Just old guys. One's got hair. How come I'm just bouncing off everywhere I hit? Let me attack you! Why do you hate me? Mr. Kent. The actor of Jukes and Hazlin, Smallville. Never watched it.
I think that's a different actor, Chaz.
I've never watched Smallville either, because I ain't watched nothing with Superman in it. Superman sucks.
Smallville was okay, but after like one or two seasons, I was done. Like, I don't know, I tend to be like that with shows. Like Buffy the Vampire Slayer, I liked it for like two or three seasons, and I was done. Like, I don't know.
I'll only watch it if I'm watching the team, though.
They just keep reusing the same storylines after a while, and it's like, okay, I get it. Can we like move on? And it's like, Dragon... no, okay.
Superman is just a knockoff of Dragon Ball Z. Hmm. It's just an alien boy sent to Earth. Raised by parents, doesn't know his powers till he's older.
Well, we're getting a Man of Steel 2, apparently.
That's why.
I don't know, I like Man of Steel. It didn't do well. I know a lot of people did not like it. I like Man of Steel.
Is Zack Snyder touching it?
Ugh. Zack Snyder, it was weird that they got Zack Snyder to do all the DC movies. Like, why? Why do you need one director?
Because I really want to watch my movies in 4x3, bro. It's my vision.
That was weird. Yeah, the Snyder Cut was like black and white and 4x3, wasn't it?
Yeah, I don't know if it was black and white, but I know it was 4x3, and I'm just like, there's no reason for this, Mr. Snyder.
It's cinematic, bro.
Is it, though? Mm. Alright, that's why I only play my new consoles on CRTs. Mm. I think technically, like, you can natively play a PS3 on RF if you really want to.
But the PlayStation 5 can't play PlayStation 3 games natively.
Sick.
Cloud hype.
No, don't do that. Strength wants to do that. Why does he hate himself?
Okay, Strength wants to do what?
Wants to play a PS3 and RF.
Oh. Well, Strength is interesting. He loves CRTs. Like, he played Blasphemous on a CRT. It actually didn't look that bad because of the art style of Blasphemous.
Ooh, interesting. I might try that.
But I think he had to squish the aspect ratio because that game is 16:9. Yeah. So I don't know. That's weird.
Yeah, it's weird.
But yeah, I don't like how CRTs look. I think it looks blurry and I don't like it.
Yeah, well, oh, that was the one thing I hated about playing Castlevania 4. I remember there was no non-CRT filter that wouldn't fill the whole screen.
I didn't realize that. That's weird.
Dumb. Israel, boys and girls. Hello, Steve. How are you? I would read it all out, but I can't.
Imagine Stevie playing Monster Hunter.
I think he does, maybe.
No.
Oh, never mind. I made it up. So yeah, CRTs are overrated. I'm just going to say it.
Yeah, no, they always do these comparisons of like, look how the pixels look on a CRT versus a HD. And I'm like, it looks better on the HD. But then everyone's saying, no, it looks better on the CRT. And I'm like, I don't get it. I guess my eyes are different. I don't know.
I think it looks just fine on an HDTV. Especially if you got HDMI mods. Love butts.
Love butts.
Stevie loves butts. You know what? Wait, hold up. I'm going to add quote this. This seems like old school TVs are overrated. I don't feel like breaking my back for fucking to carry a TV. Thank you. Oh, that's quote 500. Stevie, you are quote 500. Congratulations. Looking for something new or another? Listen, we're Stevie's probably part of the CRT crew. We don't mean to offend you. We love you. That skull mask. How do I get that?
Cool.
I need to find an eroded skeleton.
I'm sure that's easy to find.
I want it so bad. So what can I help you with? Oh, that's so fucking cool. Tell me what
you need. Stitches must be very strong to lift that.
Damn, Stitch, you're jacked as fuck, bro. 175 pounds? Jesus. Like, listen, I don't need to break my anus to lift the TV, okay? The TV's a double of the table. Those were cool. I will say, aesthetically, those were cool. Pay with points, order the usual. Alright. Keep forgetting we have to do that.
Yeah, how come they don't make like a modern TV in like a wooden frame? Like they like the old school TVs.
Oh, probably because they realize it doesn't your TV doesn't need to weigh 200 fucking pounds anymore. Let's see. We can hunt a
four stitched.
Zigzagging Zapper.
The GameCube was very portable, had a little handle.
That's not what the handle was for.
But it's the only console that had a handle. I don't think they ever...
It was not intended to be a handle.
It was. You just carried around like a...
No, it was a bumper for your wall. So when you plugged your cables in, people didn't shove the GameCube to the wall. It was never meant to be...
Interpretation?
No, that's what it was...
Where are you hearing that from? Right. Never heard that.
What was the handle on the GameCube for? I'm telling you. Don't you ring your bell at me, Stitch. All right. There's even a Reddit thread, and we all know Reddit is smart.
That's not true.
Reddit's not smart.
You just made that up.
Listen, why does the GameCube have a handle? It was designed
around like a lunchbox.
God damn it! It's a bumper. I'm trying to figure out where I ran it.
To take your GameCube to your friend's house.
It's not true. Of course, now the article I'm finding is dead. Oh my god, now I'm a liar. No, listen, it had a... okay, whatever, fine. It's a bumper. Because dumb kids would plug their stuff in and then they'd shove it up against the wall and break the cables and go, why broken? Why are all the Japanese in North America? Because you can't... Yeah, listen, you can still use it as a handle. You can carry your... You can play your controller by holding the analog sticks like nipples, too. What's your point? You ever see people who used to play like NES by laying the controller flat on the table?
No, but did you see like the way Sakurai plays Smash Brothers? He puts the Pro Controller on a table.
Yeah.
And he puts like two of them on the table and he puts both of his hands on it. Like, I don't know how he plays like that.
Yeah, they play flat like that. I can't do that. Mm-mm. What if their controller rumbles?
Oh.
It's over. You can still use it as a handle. It's just not meant for it, I promise. I wonder if there's any components in the handle, like if you cut it open. Also, I don't know, does anyone know who Peter Netter is on YouTube? He made a round GameCube for no reason.
GameSphere?
Yeah, he kind of like, listen, I could gaslight all my friends by telling them the GameCube was actually a circle. They'll all be fools. Look at me.
I've seen very creative, you know, things of people recycling their GameCube.
He also made a DS out of cardboard.
Okay.
Yeah, he just took all the guts out, put it in a cardboard shell. He's like, I have no idea why I did this, but it works. He has a lot of dumb projects like that, but he's really funny. Mm. What if Metroid could crawl? We'll never know, Steve. Mm. What if Metroid could crawl? What if Link was a grill? Mm. Or fuck, Zelda. Shit. I fucked it up. Oh well. Where's the monster?
Linkle. They made Linkle.
Oh yeah, what? Where's Linkle at? I forgot about that.
Linkle was a thing.
Where did they do with her? And she wasn't even in Breath of the Wild, was she?
They made up Linkle for the 3DS port of Hyrule Warriors, and then they put it on the Switch as well.
And then they forgot about it.
Yeah, Linkle was only made for that game at that time. Doesn't exist anywhere else.
I think we need to have a search. Where the hell's Linkle?
I don't know.
Emergency evade, yes. Alright, I'm
still. She had her own story mode, so I guess they do explain where she came from, but I only played the Wii U version of Hyrule Warriors, so I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. I gotta replay that game too. I started it and I never finished.
It's good. The story mode's pretty fun, actually.
I feel like that story was like really long, unless I'm crazy.
Yeah, it was pretty girthy.
I'll play it on the Wii U, Steve. So I can play it in all its 480p glory.
It's a HD console.
Well, if you play split screen, it goes 480.
Oh, but you're not playing split screen, so.
I will make Tina play with me. I just don't get how they managed to do that. Also, I think we're fighting the wrong monster. No, wait, kill the thing. It's an Narukuga. forgot. Yeah, I just don't know why the TV resolution matched the tablet when you did that.
Well, the reason why is because it's running the game twice.
Oh, that's right.
So that's putting a lot of strain on the hardware.
You should have just gotten two tablets. Mm. I still want to know what the port on the bottom of the Wii U tablet's for.
They never used that. I think that was just for retail displays where they could like bolt it to the thing. I think that.
But what? But like they didn't put like a cover on it or anything. Like
no,
it just seems weird. It could have been for a DS player, but.
Well, it was like the expansion port on the Super Nintendo, or they never used that for anything.
But at least they covered it. Oh, it's for sex. Thanks, Steve.
There you go.
Now I know. I did
fighting the wrong monster, but if
I am
kill that for Kev, then
I am killing the Narukuga because I want that armor. It looks so cool. No, get over here, you idiot! Where'd it go? 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 Come on. If you kill that, all right, fine. I'll go help get the real thing. I didn't even think about that, Steve. Now I know. Alright, where is this little guy? I really want Zombie U to... I would love to play that, but I wish I had it online. Drink water? I will, Tim. Hello. And I hit the mic. Sorry about that. Wireman. More like communist cat. That's not me. I'm not a communist. The 1960s American government will have my ass if I said that. Death. Oh my god. This thing's scary. It moves too fast.
It has little flaps like a flying squirrel.
Ooh. Flying squirrels are adorable.
Yeah, you ever see those little sugar gliders? They're so cute.
I love them.
You could just say, hey, come over here. And they will just, like, fly to you.
That's so cute. There's a bunny in my yard I'm trying to get to be my friend. I try to keep feeding him lettuce and carrots, and he just gets scared of me.
Aw.
Too intimidating. Your sister had a sugar glider? That's cool. Adorable.
Yeah, they're very tiny, and they're very cute.
I love small animals. There's a list of so many animals that I want to pet, but they definitely won't let me. Like a raccoon? I just want to pet a raccoon real bad. Little
I
bandit.
Rabies.
Listen, they're just little trash pandas. They just want snacks. I'm willing to give them snacks for hugs.
The raccoons seem to always want snacks.
Yeah, and they don't care what it is. I feel bad for them. Are they just homeless? Like, maybe I just need to protect them. I'll protect you, Mr. Trash Panda. You don't need to be a robber anymore. Take your mask off. Or like those little frogs, like the poison dart frogs, I just want to pet.
Aw.
They're so cute, and they're so colorful.
Rabies for Kev. Let's get the hashtag going.
That would be good. Also, everyone, go find that Manscaped tweet and like start tagging me. I really want to, I'll shave on stream.
I think that's a violation of terms of service.
Listen, I just want to be, I want a sponsorship for Manscaped. I use it not every day. I use it enough. Well, listen, Chaz, there's nothing wrong with shaving your face on stream. What do you think I was talking about?
Mm-hmm. Face is quote in quotation marks.
I will shave my head, giggity.
Which head?
Sponsor me to find out. Mm. Oh, I need that material. Toby Kodachi. Toby Kobayashi Riku material. Nice.
Yes.
Kobayashi Kodachi? Which one works best? Which, by the way, everyone go download the podcast. Thanks. Love you for it. Too bad Aaron died and got bit by snakes in the throat, so he'll be back next week.
Oh.
Yeah, he died. It's real unfortunate. I do a podcast once or twice, Steve. Once or twice a year. I could probably fight one more thing after this, and then I gotta get going, unfortunately.
Alright.
No, he's not sick. He had like, work things. And then he had to go do the Bristle Rassles, so he's a busy boy. And honestly, if Aaron's getting back into wrestling and it may give him scheduling problems, I'm fine with that. I want Aaron to be happy boy. We'll make it work.
Stevie should be your new podcast partner.
Honestly, Steve did a great job.
Yeah, he did.
Who is that? Oh, it's Ash Williams. But oh my god. All right, so Ash Williams is in Fortnite, but his chainsaw is locked to being a harvester tool. That's funny.
I don't know who that is.
You know Evil Dead?
Yes.
That guy.
Okay.
All right, I can kill one more thing.
You thought it was Walking Dead.
Yeah, whatever, it's the same thing. Ashley. Listen, you mean, I don't know. Wait, Mega Man, time for your vaccination.
Oh, what? You mean that racist Ashley Williams?
Does this space racist? Oh, yeah, her name was Williams in life. My space racist wife. This who luckily, phobic. When I play the third game, I won't have to deal with this. Who are we going to raid after this?
I played the original Mass Effect twice, and each time I had her die.
Why? Why do you hate her so much?
Because she's a racist.
Allegedly.
It's like, you know, our whole team is of different races. We can't have somebody who's, like, acting like that. That's not being a team player.
She's misunderstood. I can't even defend her. She's a terrible racist. All right, I got a raid plan. We'll do one more. And then I got a plan, a new friend of ours. All right, let's kill. Who are we killing? Who are we killing?
I do think that was a very interesting, because what other game has a racist character in it? Like, I think that's the only one I could think
Mafia 3.
I guess so. But I thought that was a very interesting, like, choice story-wise.
I mean, it made sense. Like, if I, like, I know this is gonna, I'm gonna sound bad, but if I'm in space, I don't know what these aliens want to do. Maybe they do want to kill us. They're aliens.
Well, it's the same way the council didn't trust making him a... What's the title again?
I kept her alive, Steve. I know everything.
But they didn't trust, you know, Shepard because he was human. So it was kind of the same way.
Or three, she... Yeah, that's what Aaron was saying too, Chaz. She becomes less racist by three. So... But
you have to get to that point.
Well, I know up to two, Steve, there. All right, we're going to play Mass Effect 3.
It's like, I'm going to keep you alive because you're going to be not racist later. Like, that doesn't work for me.
It's a character arc. I want potions, you dummy. Really hate how this box works sometimes. All right, Stitch. He's ringing the bell. All right, last one, and then we'll plan our raid. Muchos hornos. My tummy made a noise. What's tomorrow? Tomorrow I might, maybe I'll do like an early stream. I don't know, depending on what time it is. I gotta leave by like 1 tomorrow. Maybe I won't do anything. Who knows? Two of your Mass Effect aliens were real and I have trust issues too. See, you're getting it. I thought you were ringing the bell, Stitch. My bad.
But yeah, imagine if E.T. was real. That would scare the fuck out of me.
E.T. did scare the shit out of me.
I never understood. Why did they make E.T. so scary looking? This was a movie for children.
Horrifying. That little alien creeps the fuck out of me.
He just looks really bizarre.
Yeah. Oh, I thought you... Okay, sorry, my bad, Stitch. I forgive you. I forgive you for the thing I misunderstood. Is this the monster?
You just found out what that bell meant?
I thought he was manually ringing the bell to be like, guys, hurry up, guys, hurry up, guys, hurry up.
Oh, well, you can do that. You can go back and forth and it's annoying, but if you just ring it once, you're not trying.
That's what happens when you play with randos, I'm sure.
Yes.
I hate when games have like lobbies that do that.
He was a botanist? Well, he could, you know, make a dead plant come back to life. I guess that makes him a botanist.
Or he's Jesus doing miracles that don't do anything. Check it out, water into wine, baby.
Well, I thought it was cool that, you know, E.T. had healing powers. He would be good on a team. He would be the healer.
Which Johnny Five being attacked in Short Circuit 2. I don't know what any of that sentence means. Who's Johnny Five? What's Short Circuit?
Aww, Kev was born in 1992.
Short Circuit?
Short Circuit was about a robot who looked like Rob, the NES robot.
Oh, cool.
It was, yeah, very cool.
Why is every monster right here?
But yeah, the robot struck by lightning and he becomes alive. So he's like sentient.
Oh.
But no one believes him. And then he meets a girl who thinks he's from outer space. But then when she finds out he's just a robot, she gets pissed. But it's a happy ending, though. So it's a good movie.
Gotcha. Yeah, Short Circuit to me is a tech YouTube channel that I watch. Linus Tech Tips and all.
Oh, yeah. Like, he's desperate for input, so he reads, like an entire encyclopedia in, like, 5 seconds. And he's like, need more input.
Is he Rain Man?
Sort of. But yeah, he was just kind of obsessed with obtaining data at a fast rate. So he would watch TV, he would read books, and he would learn everything.
He's just a knowledge boy.
Yeah, and then he would start like using like random catchphrases he learned from TV shows. It was pretty funny.
That would be like those YouTube videos that, like, I forced an AI to watch 40 Olive Garden commercials. And here's the result.
Like, yeah, if you had Johnny Five just watch random YouTube, like, that would be his language and his culture, and it would be funny. But yeah.
Sick. All right. Eh. Did you see, actually, speaking of AI, Steve, did you ever see a video by Cultaholic called I Force an AI to Watch Every Episode of Monday Night Raw, and it produced its own episode? It is hilarious. Oh god, get away from me.
Oh yeah, in the sequel, he put a toolbox around his laser because he was a pacifist, so he didn't want his laser to be used.
And I assume during the movie he uses the laser.
Yes.
Because...
Well, toward the end, he gets revenge and, yeah, bad stuff happens. But yeah, yeah.
I really like how we've learned how, like, in every movie, robots become sentient and they try to kill us, and every day we're like, introducing the new Google Home. Like, guys, when did you learn?
There was that Will Smith movie, I, Robot. Wasn't that the whole plot?
That's like every robot movie. Oh. It was like, we should stop making them more sentient. But also, hey, Google, turn off my lights. Oh, wait, don't do that shit. Hmm. I forgot. I have smart plugs. Don't do that. My Wi-Fi router has a Google thingy in it. Ooh, god, jeez. Alexa and your cat are conspiring against you? Oh, no! Alright, gotta sharpen my fucking hammer. That's an energy drink. Got a monster, baby. Where's my pet stand? There it is. Shing. Got him! I like you guys. Thanks.
He died as soon as I put a trap.
That sucks, but that's alright. Carving, carving, carving. We're carving. Alright, let me get my read button ready. Alright, let me see. Alright, I'll get that ready. I just want to go to check my stuff real quick before I do it. What does it? Now with the latest Verizon router, you can send message to text movement in your home, no additional hardware. That's weird. How does it know everywhere in my home? My router's in my basement.
Yeah, how does the router see movement? So the router has eyeballs?
Or an infrared thing, maybe.
Hmm.
Ideas, mate. Ow, my elbow's cracked. Fuck, that hurt. I'm old. Help
crack
me.
Crack is whack.
I'm old, guys. I can't move anymore. Or is it Rob?
I don't know what an EDI is.
Is it EMMI? EMMI? Is that what it is?
MDNA?
What's the thing for Metroid? EMMI, right?
I don't I'm not able to find it out. Yeah, I wouldn't enable it either.
Yeah, it sounds sketchy. But, all right, guys. I gotta get going. Thank you for playing with me. I love your faces.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Bye.
And for everybody else, we... go to the Kev Cam. Well, that's not the Kev Cam. We are going to raid Jack Attack, who's a nice guy. I raided somebody random, and it's a good time. He's playing Bioshock. So if you're into Bioshock, you should go, let's go raid him. And I'll see you guys over there for a bit. And then I gotta get going. But love your faces. Goodbye.